one, two.
You got the reference?
Jackass! Little blogger twerp, you'll do fucking nothing!
The ConorG Show. Crawford cameras are down. Welcome in, Rob. This one is Ricky Force with Make It Right.
We'll be right back.
Welcome in, Rare Witch. Welcome in, everybody. You're about to witness the ConorG Show. Strap it up, strap it in. Let me begin. It's the rootin' tootin' highfalutin' ConorG Show. Who came here to party?
Choose is suitable for the audience at home. To help you understand what the film is like, you may look at the certificate it has been given. This film has been classified a PG. This stands for potential gratification. Films with violence, sex, and drugs may be too arousing for a teenager. It means that parents may wish to check the film before showing it to their children. If it's an action film, it might contain bloody violence. If it's romantic, it might have some sexy scenes or very brief nudity and or sexual swearing. Video certificates are there to give you a chance to make the right choice. Thanks for listening.
Baby was born with perfect hair. His name was Connor and he didn't even care. When he looked in the mirror said I. Then he said, what? Is it I nah? Is it I so I've got to go? Press the button and start the show. Give me 2 seconds while I blow my nose. Clear my throat and pick my hole. You're now tuned into the Connor Gillespie Show.
Welcome to the Conor G Show. I'm your host, and this is the Conor G Show. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I have for you a little presentation that'll take you through the dirty depths of the interwebs. Starting in Northern Ireland, spanning across the globe. The biggest freaks and weirdos and cool people you'd ever hope to know. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have Dirty Dinners featuring Marcus O'Leary and Tug of War. The Freaky Freestyle Face-Off featuring Emcee Chad Rooeny, RKid and Oisin Crawford. Then we have... Rockstar Responds to Meek N. Jed battles the Heathens, and Emcee addresses the allegations, and Paul Morrissey train, recover, eat, all that and more on tonight's Conor G Show. Cheers, everybody. Here by the grace of psychic Glen, go we. This one is Projection with Love Struck. It's when I get close to know. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Who's ready to have some fun? Oh, and a late addition to the credits tonight. Introducing Mashtag Brady to the ConorG Show. We've caught Mashtag. We've caught my favourite TikToker up to no good. Maybe not up to no good, but he certainly... I caught him trying to be a wee bit sneaky. And I thought I would just show you what I've been watching. The sort of content that I watch behind closed doors.
Singular F. What people think about you.
The rare which you don't like Mashtag. Well, you'll have a chance to share your opinions on him later on tonight. All right, let's get this party started. So come on, come on, and lay your head by mine. And I'll show you my love just to be the moon. Is it true, just in love? Come on, Glen. Let's get this party started. So there you go. Yet another similarity between me and Glen. That's how I dance as well. Okay, so, all right, thank you, Glen. Let's get this party started. He's a wee braver. Me and Glen are from that rave lifestyle, from that rave era. All right, thank you, Glen. Let's get this party started. All right, so isn't this excited? The Rockstar Meek N response has been leaked. We've been waiting. I was hoping for this weeks ago, but someone leaked it and it made its way into my inbox. So we'll be checking that out. I'm sure it's going to be fan dabby dozy. So we got Freestyle, some Chad Rooney, RKid and Oisin Crawford making his debut on the ConorG Show. How's all the audio levels tonight? Is everything okay? Or are your ears bleeding? Are your eyes sore? Welcome in, everyone. So glad to see you all here tonight. So is anybody watching tonight who didn't get to see last week's show because that was the first one that was behind the paywall? Thank you so much for the people who are signed up to the Ko-fi membership. There's also an option if you don't want to become a member, right, and pay for the subscription to see the show. There's also a one-time support button which will give you access for like 30 days. I'm gonna really win. So you can check that out as well. Check out all the hidden vids where I go too mental, so I have to take it down in public view. So yes, thank you. And I will be posting a little one or two clips from last week's show probably to YouTube to wet people's whistles. The people that missed out on a few things, we'll touch on that a bit more later. So it's not bonus extra content that I'm putting up behind the paywall. It's the show. So if you miss that one, you're behind on the show. You're not up to date with all the latest goss and news and rap beefs. No other. So tonight we're starting early with Dirty Dinners. We're coming straight in with Dirty Dinners nice and early tonight.
Dirty, dirty dinners, these are dirty, dirty dinners. Dirty, dirty dinners, these are dirty, dirty dinners.
Thank you to Ducky Mia, subscribed for 17 months. Thank you so much for your generosity. I'll do my best not to shout at Ducky Mia. I'll bite her head off for trying to help out.
The picture's bogging and your arteries are clogging.
Marcus Sweeney's back on Dirty Dinners tonight.
You're better doing nothing, and I'm not even laughing.
We haven't played Dirty Dinners for quite some time. I feel like the Dirty Dinners hit a crescendo when we saw Christopher Mellon aka Dublin Social's drug trafficking exploitation film.
The food looks taken. What were you thinking?
I said, did I say Marcus O'Leary, not Marcus Sweeney? Did I say Marcus Sweeney?
Next time you ask permission when you want to use the kitchen.
There's a brand new Marcus Sweeney channel point redemption. You got to be a big time rich spender to get that one. And that's for, we will dip into the Pair podcast where Marcus Sweeney's doing an interview in HD and you can really see the fake tan on him.
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
Right, so what have we got? What have we got? Did you miss Dirty Dinners? I think people hate Dirty Dinners. Let's see, Rob says, I was going to say, is Marcus Sweeney eating a cake made out of oxters?
Here's my message to you oxters.
A nice oxter stew, perhaps. Right, so, I saw this horrible little video and it made me so mad. This came up on TikTok. This is now the TikTok review show. Although Mashtag Brady, I will be reviewing his YouTube vlogs later, so stay tuned for that. Check it out. So this is the Shrooms guy. So this is Dirty Dinners.
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
So as far as I know, I started watching this because I thought, oh, have they legalized mushrooms or something? No, these are like a supplement or something that people take. Some people take mushrooms as a supplement, but they market it as magic mushrooms. You know, the way like weed is marketed as sweets, you know, like kids' candy. So they... It looks like they're marketing these just edible mushroom supplements. Or have I got this completely wrong and he is just selling mushrooms? As far as I can tell, these are just like mushroom supplements, right? To help you sleep or focus or something like that. I guess you will be able to see quite quickly why this is featured on Dirty Dinners here.
I've got the star shrooms, right?
And literally- English! Only joking.
They're just my go-to at the minute. So this is probably like the third packet I've got. It's no great secret that I got ADHD. Love it.
So, people whose personality is that they have ADHD. I hate these people. These people are... I'm not talking about people with ADHD here. Let me make that perfectly clear. People who make ADHD their main character trait. People who use it as an excuse to fly about their lives like a train wreck. Mashtag Brady coming up later tonight. I hate this. No secret to me. I got ADHD. Oh! Sorry, are you in Channel 4's The IT Crowd?
Got.
Are you in Channel 4's Phone Shop?
It's no great secret that I got ADHD.
Why is that not a great secret? Is this not a shameful disease? Like the other diseases with letters? COVID? And the other ones?
Love it.
I love it. Oh. So, yeah, I sort of use guys like this here to make me like people like Jed a bit more.
They're just my go-to at the minute. So this is probably like the third packet I've got. It's no great secret that I got ADHD. Love it.
I haven't got past this point in the video. As soon as I saw that, I downloaded it and thought, you're going on Dirty Dinners, son.
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
Let's see what else he has to say now. I don't know where this is going to go. It could be a big flop bust. Tucking me off says, we don't need to go past it. Okay, but let's just see. Let's just see a wee bit. If there's nothing here, we'll cut it off.
But these have just been like a constant source where they've just, it's not been like the hit. So like with having ADHD, I drink a lot of coffee.
So not helping yourself. Not helping yourself there. Having ADHD, I drink a lot of coffee. What's the correlation here? What's the correlation? You have ADHD, so you're bouncing off the wall, so then you're tired, so then you need to drink coffee? Or is it you are... This is too early in the show to get this angry at someone for nothing. Let's continue here. I want to try and formulate some thoughts about these people who use ADHD as one of their main character traits. You ever speak to someone and within 5 minutes of knowing them, they're bringing up that they have ADHD? Most of these wee rappers.
And then that gives you a massive hit. And then...
So ADHD is an excuse for being... living your life like there are no consequences.
You have a massive, massive slump.
There are people with ADHD who are completely normal people. I'm talking about these freaks!
So it's a real high, a real low. If there's just no even balance, these literally... just keep me going for like today. I'm doing 6 till 3 shift. 6 a.m., 4 p.m. Yeah, 6 a.m. till 3 p.m. I've finished, I've come back. And I'm not... haven't got my crash yet, but...
Could you also be on, like, Adderall or something? Some other sort of methamphetamine?
Coming. No, it's coming. So this just sustains me going into night on a really easy level.
So Rob says, why don't you just buy mushrooms and eat mushrooms? Because he's got ADHD, Rob. He hasn't got the wherewithal to get to a shop, buy something, plan a recipe, and execute said recipe. Never mind, eat of an entire meal. He needs to have his, meals in pill form. Obviously. Snake oil detected, says Rob. Is he going to make a mushroom supplement sandwich? He probably grates it over pasta. Pasta and sauce. It's a hippie speedball, says Tababo. Coffee and mushroom dust, like it's the new speedball, they're saying.
And then later on tonight, about, I don't know, 8, 9 o'clock, me and Luke go to bed, and then I'll get up and do it all again tomorrow. But there's no, like, you take 2 of them a day. Well, you take as many as you want. But it says up to 2 a day. I probably do take 2. I probably take 1.
Thank you for that.
Early morning, like 9-ish. And then again when I come home, and then because...
So this is not an ad here.
It's so easy when I come home, I could just go to sleep. I could literally just lay on the sofa with the dogs and that's it. I'm out for the count. But yeah, so give them a go.
So notice he has the wild influencer's stare, patented by the likes of Jed, Marcus O'Leary. You know when you're doing a little thing down to your phone and you need to get your plugs in before that little circle fills up? So you're keeping a close eye on it there. It's all that matters. There's lots of instructions on eating them is hilarious, says Ducky Mia. Literally no proof, just a load of rubbish then, says Rob. Yeah, I just have these, drink a load of coffee, and then go to bed at 8 o'clock at night. I don't know about you, but adults who work... their evening starts about 8.
Actually really good.
We can't all be influencing fake magic mushies now, can we?
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
Right, so anybody who this ADHD thing is a part of your personality, I'm not talking to people with ADHD. Let's get that out of the way in case someone tries to use that against me. Talking about these people who the first thing out of their mouth when you meet them is, I have ADHD, watch out, I'm going to fuck you over pretty soon. You remind me of him, you look like him, you act like him, you don't want to be like him, do ya? Alright, I'll be on those mushroom supplements on the next show probably.
How did you manage to make such a leaping sandwich?
Alright, so this next one is called... Man gives sausage and toast a 10 out of 10. Do we have audio with this bad thing here?
English breakfast.
Yes, we do. Right, so we got this absolute giant of a man here. He looks incredibly uncomfortable in his own skin. That's what I always think when I see these giant muscle-bound guys. It's like it's painful just to exist for them. It's like everything just strains. It's like, you know how much effort it takes just to put a t-shirt on when you're this big? This is like, you know, I imagine it's difficult to tie up your shoelaces, to just do simple things.
What's the rating out of 10?
Definitely 10.
So he has just taken a single bite of toast and given it a 10.
Guys, this is one breakfast you must try. I'm at Trilogy and I'm having a full English breakfast.
Oh, so we did have a bite of sausage there. Very pale, very false looking sausage. There we go.
What's the rating out of 10?
He ate so little of that, I don't know why he's wiping his mouth. He ate two of the most dry things on the plate.
Definitely 10.
Definitely a 10.
Guys, this is one breakfast.
Alright, I just needed to show you. Man gives sausage and toast 10 out of 10. Hold on, let's check these comments here. Let's check these comments, make sure we're not missing anything.
Guys, this is one breakfast you must try.
The one breakfast you must try. Hard. Hard, hard, hard. And he has turned the comments off.
I saw that lettuce, but now I wish I hadn't.
You know what that means?
Tomato whistle hanging out the side.
Ah, today we are going back to one of our early guests on Dirty Dinners. His name is Tug of War.
The bread is looking mangled, like as if something has died. Your omelet's overdone, your head is...
Do a remix here. It's the dub version. Right, okay. So, we almost didn't make it to air this week on the ConorG show, and I was thinking, oh my god, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna have to make last week's show that I made a big announcement about coming live, or, you know, putting that episode behind the paywall, and then this episode's gonna be free, and then alternating like that forever into time. So I'm gonna have to make last week's episode public now that I'm taking another week off again. That's because I got some grit in my eye or something. My eye ended up looking like this here, like Tug of War. Do you remember this classic episode of Dirty Dinners where he's over at Mama War's house? Shout outs to Mama War. And, you know, she was feeding him worm feed, basically. And he was on camera like this here, and he's like, oh, I've got a sty in my eye. I didn't have a sty. It was just a bit swollen and red, but it did look similar to this. So I was thinking, I want to cancel the show. I'm going to cancel the show. I can't go on camera like this, especially after making fun of Tuggy here for doing the same thing. Luckily, Ducky Meow gave me some advice here. She said, put a cold tea bag on it. And I immediately was like, what's the scientific theory behind this? It's just a soothing feeling on your eye. So I tried it, and here we are live today, so it must have worked there. All right. So that's beside the point.
Dirty dinners. Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
We just have a brand new one from Mama War and Tug of War here. This one is called... I titled this image Tuggaslop. So big shout, I can't remember who sent me this, but someone sent me this. Obviously, I don't know. Well, maybe it's not obvious, but Tug of War has me blocked on every single social media platform. I don't think I've ever interacted with him other than doing my funny wee video saying, "You're not as hard as you portray." Welcome in, Shanzini, Tug E Fresh. So yes, this one I call Tuggaslop. Shout out to the person who sent me this. I'm so sorry I can't remember who. But thank you to the people who keep an eye on all the buffoons for me and sent me all the best pieces. Even if I don't show them on the show, I assure you I've kept them in a folder for a rainy day in case we need to reference it. So look at this. We've got some bread here laden with rat turds. And then he's got some margarine on top there, probably lard. And then we've got some beyond overcooked broccoli here. And then behind that, we've got some homeless diariki. It's burnt, says Rob. And he would know about vegetables.
Could have used a filter for your undercooked fish fingers.
Oh yeah, speaking of Rob, our friend Rob here does this wonderful program on Twitch every other Saturday. It's called Dollar for a Dong. You give him as little as a quid and he'll paint your wildest fantasies for you. My wildest fantasies come in the form of the characters that you see on this program. Here's Tug of War. If you don't know who he is, he's just a wee one of our top faking Jamaicans. And Rob did a little painting of this for me. And it was... This is the painting here. We haven't got the high-res scan yet. Rob's a busy man. But here's the lovely painting that he managed to do for us. Let's do a little side-by-side here. Should have used a filter for your undercooked fish finger. It really makes me shudder when I see you spread some butter. It was lying in a lump in the middle of the bed. I wanted chicky-chicky, but made food coloring instead.
Makes me wanna shudder when I see you spread some butter.
Not the most aesthetic thing in the world. Are you talking about lentils or this painting, Rob? Right, let's see. There you go. There's this beautiful little painting. Let me just take a little screenshot here of this for my and Rob's records. There you go. Screenshot secured. Coin, 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 coin. Shout outs to Snowy Danger. All right. That was Tuggy Tuggy. It's a tug a tug world. For days.
And yes, I saw your waffle. And yes, it did look awful.
Quality painting, Rarewit says in the chat. So, what do we have next here in Dirty Dinners?
I also saw falafel. That was a debacle.
Right, this little piece I call John Fallons, the Capstan Bar with the Toastie Threat. Dun, dun. Do I have my sinister music on here? One of Dublin's infamous pubs called the Capstan Bar.
Salute your optimism, but there's better food in prison. I'm not in a position to be dropping any wisdom, but that sausage casserole you've been listening to service.
Sorry about that. What was I saying? Oh yes, John Fallons, the Capstan Bar, made a little video promoting their horrid toasty. Now, I am a giant hater of not toasties that you get in bars. I like them. I mean, they're fine. They serve one purpose: to line your stomach so you can drink more pints. They are not something fancy. They're not something decadent. They're not something lovely. They're not a lovely hug in a mug. They are not to be exploited, put on a pedestal, fawned over, influenced. by two. They are an essential part of life, like a packet of crisps. They serve one purpose. Line the stomach, get more drink in ya, right? They're free in a lot of pubs, right? They're hideous. They're horrible. They're unhygienic. They're bland. They're borderline disgusting, right? And I eat a lot of them throughout my life. I have ate a lot of them. So I always get triggered when I see... I think we've covered them on the show before. Maybe... not sure if Joanne Cronin or Ali Dunworth or whatever her name is. One of those Dublin influencers. I've seen them post about these bar pub toasties and I'm very, very unimpressed.
Mea culpa, yeah.
So this one came across my timeline. Let's see what... John Fallon's The Capstan Bar. Terrible name, by the way.
Lest I be litigated.
Not a fan of the name of that bar. Anyway, let's continue. So, first things first, they got the worst type of bread. Brennan's bread is... Bannon's Batch loaf is the worst bread. The worst bread possible that you can get. It's thin... Its texture is not fluffy, it's thin, it's brittle, it's like foam, you know, it's not like a nice soft bread. The crust is all burnt and it falls off almost instantly, so it's like, and it's cheap, it's shitty, it's cheap, it's, you know, you feed it to the birds. So I resent this. Bowling pin setup that you've slid in here. John Fallon, if that is your real name. All right. Don't get me all redeemed the lie counter. Let's whack it up here. Okay, like it, says Ducky me incorrect rebred. Batch bread is the goat. Says Hammer to your mother. No, you're wrong. It's the worst type of bread. I give you several examples of why it was the worst kind. None of you have given any reason why it's nice. It's horrible. It's horrible. It comes pre-stale, and it lasts about 4 seconds in the cupboard. All right, let's whack this lie counter on here. The new people don't get the rules of dirty dinners yet. There's one rule of dirty dinners. Compliment what's on the screen, and you're out of here for life. You made an enemy. All right, let's continue with this here. Is the lie counter up? There we go. All right, let's continue. Toasties at Fallon's. They've got all the worst ingredients. Okay, so FYI, we only use batch bread here at Fallon's. That's a negative. The lie counter starts at one, okay? So far, there's no lies here. This is just an ad for... some basic stomach filler. Hopefully this song doesn't get us all muted out. If this song gets me muted out and I have to do some editing of this stream, I'm going to hold John Fallon personally responsible. Look at it! Yous are all like, oh, Butch bread is the best! Look at it! It's like so thin and... It's like cardboard. Look at it. It's pathetic. It's so thin. This is like a coaster. Rob says, I hope they're not charging for these. Well, the good pubs don't. Good pubs will just give the regulars these, right? So I'm not discrediting them in that way. What I don't like is people bigging them up as if they're something when they're actually nothing. There we go. We've got some watery ham and we got some genetically modified tomatoes. Some onion, some cheese. And they're doing it sunny side up. And then don't make sure you burn the outside and put butter on the outside. And then put it back in. So here we have someone who doesn't... Someone is a bar, a pub, right? Not a cafe, not a restaurant. The person who's making an advert about the toasties doesn't understand the fundamentals of a cheese toastie. Hands up in the chat. if anyone knows why you butter the outside of a cheese toastie, hands up. It's clearly because when you're doing a grilled cheese, which is a different style of cheese and toast, there are many styles. A toasted cheese sandwich, aka a toastie, is not buttered on the outside. That is a grilled cheese that you butter on the outside to stop it from sticking to the pan. I don't see any pan here. Apart from the pan loaf. So it's completely unnecessary to put it on the outside. You've burnt it already, mate. Excuse me. Mr. Fallon. You've burnt it already. No point in putting butter on the outside and then popping it back in to get more burnted. There you go. And they put a wee HB sauce and Hellman's mayonnaise on the side there. What do they got there? What's this one? English mustard for the aristocrats in the crowd. Look at that. Horrible burnt. And then chuck some tato over it. Chuck some horrible southern tato over it. That'll cover up the damage and then a delicious looking pint. Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen.
I better let you check your backwards with your feet. Underwater on a broken F3 with no skate.
Tababo's the only one in the chat that has my back here. He says, Lamau, it's completely black on the edges. It's burnt! Let's see what the chat are saying about this. They've got a lot to say about cheese toasties. This is a cheese toastie community. The Brennan's man was always the nicest delivery man when I worked in a shop, says Ducky Meow. Well, that's your experience. Let's see. Is that cheese slices, says Rob? They are common in a cheese toastie, Rob. Yep. Ooh, Kerry made, says Ducky Mia. Correct thing to say on an episode of Dirty Dinners. Doesn't matter if your favorite food comes on this screen, pretend you hate it and come up with ways it's horrible in the middle if you're playing Dirty Dinners.
Things I see, like your naturally cheesy fries, like one or three.
Oh yeah, this segment is called the Cheese Toastie Threat. This isn't even to do with what I'm babbling on about now. This is just the setup, I think. Let's see. It's no nutty crust. It looks like Tesco value bread, says Rob. It's lower than Tesco value bread in my humble. Roasting hot tomato in your toastie. Brilliant. I'm being sarcastic. It's nice bread. Bulletproof crusts. What is this crap? Don't they have a Breville, says Rob. When you get a Breville toastie in a pub, that is the top tier type of toastie you can get at a pub. And those are shite, right? This, they're doing a lot of dressing up. They're doing a big, big polishing a turd here with all this extra stuff here. You know, with all the tomato, the onion, the everything else they've ladled around it. This is a turd polishment here. Let's get rid of that for now. It was not in vain, Ducky Mail. We'll bring that up throughout this segment if we need to. What was I babbling on about here? Oh yeah, the Breville, that's your top tier. This, I mean, look, the ham, if you're going to put ham and all this other stuff in, you got to at least make sure the ham is even mildly warmed. I can tell from looking at this is not even warmed ham. It's cold. There's nothing worse than a cold ingredient in a hot sandwich. Unless it's from Strandwiches. No one bring up sandwiches during dirty dinners. Unrelated. Then you've got your just your regular toasty that's cooked on top of a grill like that. And then you've got this kind. You know? Sorry, this is nonsense. I never butter the outside. That's too Elvis, says Rob. I butter the outside, but not the inside. Who butters the inside of a cheese toasty? I mean, there's too many variables here, right? Don G says, surely that's a grilled sandwich and not a toasty, and you wouldn't serve that burnt. Thank you, Don G. What a disaster, says Rob. Why would you not make the video again if you burnt it? Not using high quality strong cheddar. NGMI, says Robert. Robert. I just called you Robert because I don't know what NGMI means. So I was thinking about that when I was saying your name. Here's your toasty. It's burnt. Enjoy, they're saying. How much is it? Says Rare Witch. Yeah, I want to know. Probably 15.5 quid. Lol, says Rob. 14 euros, says Rare Witch. All right, maybe we'll find that out in our next little piece of business here. We've got, the Toasty Threat is up next here. Let's see what why I deemed this a threat. So, Stacky replies to this here post. Stacky 0102 says, I wouldn't be putting this on any social media. You have the environmental health officer on your back in no time. This is a CCP, open brackets, critical control point with no refrigeration by the looks of it. Just say. Looks lovely though. No, don't backpedal. John Fallons, the Capstan Bar, fires back with. Sorry, I had to sniff there. I still need to. Hi there, Stacky. Thank you for liking our reel. You should pop into us sometime for a pint and a toasty. And if you sit at the bar, you'll be able to see all of our fridges, including our dedicated food fridge. As with all bars, open brackets, drink is also considered a food item, close brackets. We are fully HACCP compliant. I'm doing Australian here. Including staff training. Trying to do Dublin accent here. The AHO calls in routinely and is happy with all. So rest assured, we have no problem highlighting our famous toasties online. Hope to see you very soon. That's a threat. That's a threat. That is a veiled threat. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's continue with Dirty Dinners.
It makes me want to shudder when I see you spread some butter. It's just lying in a lump in the middle of the bread. You want the chili chicken, but me food poison instead.
Right, shall we look up, we'll look up this up, see if we can find the price of this here toasty. Shall we?
And yes, I saw your waffle, and yes, it did look awful. I also saw falafel, that was a debacle. I salute your optimism, but there's better food in prison.
Check this, just typed it into Google there. Racist, avoid John Fallon's The Capstan Bar. Not good. Let's click on this. Let's see what they're saying here. This wasn't supposed to get this dark. When it says from 2021, I'm sure the staff has been updated. 38 euro, they're saying in the chat. 20 euro, 14 euro, 15 quid. I've made better drink at 3 a.m. Drunk, I think she means. Which is a thing I've said before. We need to know what exactly they charge for burnt bread and chips, says Rob. All right, Rob, calm down. We're going to find out. Racist. Well, let's read this racist allegation first. Racist. Visited in good faith to support local pubs in the Libertines. and where I live for a couple of take-home drinks. Take-home drinks, this must have been during the height of CVID. Instead of purchasing from the supermarket, Janat's. Having a business and lived in Dublin for many years, this is the first time I've ever been refused service or even a reason whilst in Ireland. Old man, old attitude. It's not 1970 anymore. Been in many a pub over the years and is possibly the worst I've ever been made to feel. It's hard time for us in the lockdown trying to blah, 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 blah. 10 minutes walk to support a business to be treated like this. So there's no real details there. Just refuse service. Racist. Okay, no examples. Let's go to this next one. Rude barman. So maybe he's just rude and not racist. Who knows? Yaz Flap is in the house. Welcome in. Rockstar coming up later. Let's read this rude barman one, then we'll try to find out the price of this here. If anybody's got their little Googling fingers out while I read this to try and find the price of that toasty, we can get on with Dirty Dinas. Barman was very rude, slammed the credit card machine off the floor in temper and gave out because I ordered too many Guinness. He is known for being rude, but for some reason is retained. On a positive note, the second barman, Finn, was excellent. All right, so maybe the racist allegation has been avoided here with the rude allegation. All right, so let's check out, let's see if we can find this here. Toasty Threat.
Dirty dinners, these are dirty, dirty dinners.
See if the price is on their Instagram page here. Let's make a proper investigation out of this. It's a Dirty Dinners investigation. Here's the offending article. It says, now that is a meal right there. Great food, better pint. Let's see if they... crazy how they allow people to post... It's not, it looks awful. Last time I had a toasty in Fallons was in 1996 and it looks the exact same. Mad. God, they're all talking about batch loaf as if that's good. We've ascertained it's horrible. HSE, HSE, HSE. They're saying. Good, I'm glad someone's saying that. There's a lot of people saying that this is horrible muck. I don't know where to look. If it's not here immediately, what am I going to do? Sit and spend 15 minutes Googling how much a toasty is at the Capstan bar? Probably not. Reject all. Let's see. Do they have price? They won't have a... You just gotta ask in the bar. Don't you? Complete lack of hospitality. Great dive bar. I'll have a sweaty ham and sweaty burnt sandwich, please. Do they have a website or a phone number? Just ring them. Okay, do they have a website? Probably just Facebook or something. Then you gotta log into stupid Facebook. Let's see. Optional cookies, okay. Now we gotta log in, do we? Right, there's this horrible, beautiful toasty, says Sean here. 295 likes, 40 comments. I'm guessing 10 yo-yos. All right, here we go. 650. May I remind you, some places just give you these for free. £6.50 for a filthy, disgusting sandwich on Brennan's Batch bread, which is the worst bread. No argument. There's no argument over whether that bread is disgusting and globally hated by anyone with a brain in their brain.
These are dirty, dirty dinners.
So, that's that. Capstan bar threatening people, saying, if you don't like a look at a toasty, come down and I'll batter your bollocks and so.
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
All right, we got a fun new kid on the block when it comes to dirty dinners. His name is Mickey Whips. Loving you is in my DNA. All right, okay. Yes, Bannon's Brennan's batch bread. I'm so sorry, everyone, but anybody that thinks Brennan's batch bread is good, you need to have your brain checked by a surgeon, because it's not good. It's not good. It's horrible. It's come stale. You've just been raised eating it, so you just think that's the best, because you hear people say, oh, it's the best. No, it's the shittest. It's the worst. And that is proven now that we've done this segment here. Thank you so much for paying attention to the Conor G Show and Dirty Dinners.
Dirty, dirty dinners. These are dirty, dirty dinners.
Here's Mickey Whips, ladies and gents. He's the brand new kid on the block when it comes to TikTok.
If you want to say something, say
this is Mickey Whips.
Because I ain't got the time to be waiting.
Having a tough time. He's having a tough time here. Go on, Mickey, get it out. Looks awful. Good. Looks still up and here it is. I love that he's like second guessing every movie mix. Hammered, your mother. I hate your name, Hammered, your mother. I hate that screen name. I hate reading that out. I'm just going to let you know. I hate reading that out. We're going to have to come up with a nickname for you. I'm going to call you Hammond from now on, all right? They say, my lactose intolerance is flaring up just watching this. Aww. I feel really bad for people with lactose intolerance. You can't enjoy cheese toasties. You can't enjoy Whippy. Mr. Whippy. Oh, that's so sad. I'm so sorry for you. I take back what I said about you before. And all that shit I was talking behind your back earlier as well. I don't know who you are, by the way. If we knew each other, hello. Don't bring this up in real life. Look how dilapidated this is. Don't worry, we're going to go back and point out a few of the key moments in this here. Oh, the music cuts with 23 seconds to go, and he brings it over and he shows it off, and that's it. This is like, he looks a wee bit like Shazzy from The Shankle, doesn't he? Right, so here we go. So they've got, he's talking to camera, but they've put the music over the top here, so you can't hear nothing. So he gets a greasy little Chinese box here. I'm sure it's brand new and clean. So this guy's stuff comes up in my feed all the time. And every video, it starts off with him struggling with the bottle to get the sauce out. It's like, how have you not perfected this yet? I get the vibe of this here, Mickey and his whips. This is from the account Savor Delights, but the account I believe is called Mickey Whips. I get the thing, he's just like...
you do a line and I'll do a line, honey.
I get the impression he's just got out of jail for whatever reason, nicking car stereos or something. And... he's having to go at the straight and narrow now, and he's got a wee government grant or whatever, and he's opened a wee ice cream van, and he's making a real go of it. But he has just started. He didn't know his arse from his elbow when it comes to it. He's trying. He's even opened a wee TikTok. He's got his wee girlfriend in here, or his ma, or whatever, who's filming him. But he does. It's not that he hasn't got the grips with TikTok yet. It's that he hasn't got the grips with life on the outside yet. He finally gets the syrup going, and there's no rhyme or reason to it. It's just wildly spread all over it.
If you wanna say something, say it now.
Whops it in there. Looks horrible. So this dish isn't a very good presentation dish. To start with, number one. Then the squeeze bottle so hard. Plus his outfit is not good for social media. And he's like, right, get the ice cream in the shot here. And then he blips in one, two, goes to six. But I'm hoping in a few months he's going to get this down to a few seconds. You know what I mean? A real flick of the wrist. They should have practiced a few more times before unleashing his skills onto the world. And then he finally gets them out. And it's like flopping over. It's like, it's no good. It's not a good presentation. I love that they're trying something. Now I haven't seen these before. If I knew these were available, I would have been buying these my entire life. I love this kind of Mr. Whippy ice cream. The tune is tackier than whatever feed he's making, says Hammond. Do you like this new nickname? A lot of the chat characters here, I give them nicknames. Rare Witch is Rar Watch. Ducky Meow is Darkest Meehaw. Disgrace is Disgraziad of the Walking Andrad. Rob is Robert Tababo. Oh, he doesn't have one. He's too much of a straight-laced. He's too serious. He's too much of a serious person. Don Chi. Right, sorry. Just getting to know our new friend here. Hammered your owner. God, I hate when the nicknames are something vaguely rude. Even just the fake screen name is embarrassing enough to read out, but you know, you gotta ply through here. Oh yeah, this is my favorite part of the video here. So big ups Mickey Whips. Where this is a support video for Mickey Whips. I am taking the piss, but it's out of love. How do I communicate that to Jed? This wee point that he does, like, is he talking to the camera woman? Like, get a shot of this here, or is he like, boom, check this out, everybody. So he gets a different squeeze bottle. And wildly puts it over. No rubber isn't reason, spills it on the side here. Day release is Rowish. And then he breaks up a wee Kinder Bueno. Again, no rhyme or reason, just hammering it in there. Don't leave that wee bit of plastic in there. You see that? There's a bit of plastic right here. Oh, he plucked it out the last second. So you put these two at the end and you put these two in the middle. Nice. And then the music cuts off and he's got a wee spoon there and he abandons that and he's like, ta-da! All right, that was Mickey Whips, ladies and gents. Let's see what the chat are saying here. Getting your mix up in ripped up bin bags. Yes. very good.
You got the reference?
Ganking luggage. That's what you're saying is potential. The made up crimes that we're all coming up with. He's turned it around, says Rich. He's turned the Wayans against us. Frank McCourt versus Jerry reaction would be funny, but possibly so overplayed, says Hammond. Don't know what that is.
You got the reference?
Tell me privately. Let's see. Hammered is a quote from an excellent bit of Irish TV history. Oh, this is this Frank McCourt, Jerry Hannon. I probably know it to see. I get all the references the chat makes. 5 squirts of Mr. Whippy in a plastic tray. £5, mate. Ta. I'd pay £5 for that. I'd pay £5 for that. No more, though. I'd probably be just like, leave off all the sauces and stuff. Leave in the bueno, though. Let's see. So you never... No, let's not get into your medical history here, Hammered. That is truly a crapulent, says Rob. I do want ice cream now, though. Absolutely.
Dirty dinners, these are dirty, dirty dinners.
Let's all have food hangovers now. Is anyone else so old that they get hangovers from ice cream now?
The food looks tanked. What were you thinking?
Right, so the prince, the king, the marvelous maniac of dirty dinners returns once again. It's Marcus O'Leary.
Next time you ask permission when you
Marcus O'Leary is back once again. Tell a friend. The king of dirty dinners. Stepping out for love in Dublin with yet another social media series, right? Now, some of you who've been with the Conor G show for a while, maybe if you look deep into the dark recesses of your memory, you would recognize this guy. Marcus and this fella, forget his name, they were in my first viral clip, I think. I posted this clip to Twitter, right? And it was a clip of Marcus O'Leary in the airport, and he had bumped into this fella, and he was having a beer at like 8 o'clock in the morning. And I was just like, just taking the piss out of that. Marcus was like, just bumped into Simon here, you absolute psychopath, having beers at 8 o'clock in the morning. And I just was taking the piss like that. It was like a wee 30-second clip. I posted it to Twitter, now known as X, and someone reposted it, and then a bunch of, like, loads of people retweeted and retweeted and retweeted it. And I was getting the whole entire Dublin food scene descended on my Instagram. They knew where to find me. And I just panicked. I just deleted the post from Twitter because it was too much. It was going too fast, too quickly. Too fast, too far. And I just panicked. I just deleted it. I was just like, I don't want to go viral today. So I just got rid of it. And but that's who I remember this guy from. He was the guy in the airport that Marcus was talking about. If you want to see that episode I'm talking about, head over to ConorG.show. That links you over to my Ko-fi there, and you can chip in, support the Conor G show, unlock the entire back catalog. Over 156 episodes. Flew too close to the sun, says Rare Rich. Yeah. I can't remember. Yeah, it was just such a short out of context clip, but it just, I don't know, caught the Irish Twitter's imagination or something. I was just like, nah, no thanks. I was at work or something, and I was just like, I can't be arsed with this here. Let's get it down quick. Oh God. I had chefs from every restaurant in Dublin looking at my Instagram story. And then shortly after, this producer from RTE radio show is in my DMs calling me a toxic person for making fun of Marcus's online antics. Anyway, he's back once again. He's back for Love in Dublin. He does. Do you remember all these web series that he started? He started OnlyPans. He started What's Good. He started Early Doors. Early Doors being his most successful for Love in Dublin. Now, this is a brand new one with his pal here. Maybe he'll have a different guest every week, but we've got a microphone on the table. It's for Love in Dublin. The ones he does for Love in Dublin are much more better produced. So let's check it out here. It's Marcus Returns to Dirty Dinners.
That is a very gorgeous pint.
Will we parlay your lie counter up here for this one, Ducky Meow? Because we didn't really get to play with that during the segment without any speaking in it.
Because you've got a mustache. Welcome to Snug Advisor, your guide to the best snugs in Dublin.
Snug Advisor, right? So all these series he comes up with, they come up with the name first and then the concept after, right? Why are you not going away? There you go. So again, Snug Advisor, right? Only Pans. They come up with a name first and then they have to. I always get this word wrong. I want to say like retroactively, retrospectively, retrograde, someone help me out. No one ever corrects my grammar. And play. Sorry. Gotta close this one. We've had a major malfunk. It's Dirty Dinners.
The picture's fogging and your arteries are clogging.
That is a very gorgeous pint.
Because you've got a mustache.
So there's the first lie. The Capstan Bar! Maybe I didn't I didn't watch past the first 1 second of this here. I just threw it in the notes because every time Marcus comes out with a new web series, we're going to be covering it in Dirty Dinners. It's a must. just to show that they never have any continuity. They just come up with a new one every week. Full circle, says Rowitch. Yeah. Don't you just love it when a show happens? Okay, here we go.
Welcome to Snug Advisor, your guide to the best snugs in Dublin.
We already have the Guinness guru for this.
So we're here in Fallons in the Coombe Capstan Bar, and jeez, it's absolutely glorious.
This snug was built by the workers in the Powers Whiskey Distillery, who actually built the back bar of Fallons out of old pallets from the factory as a thank you for building.
Fascinating.
Now this snug is gorgeous. It has coat hooks, which is a big thing for me. The wood is beautiful.
It has coat hooks, which is a big thing for me. Since when? You've never worn a coat in your life. They don't fit.
It's comfortable as well.
It's
beautifully stained. Oh, love it. When you've got nothing to say, you just keep barreling through and something will come out. I've never heard someone call a bar snug. Well, I guess the segment of the bar would be a snug, I'm guessing.
Truly like a nightclub of the 1800s is fantastic. I love it. So it's probably one of the more comfortable snugs in Dublin. I'd say about eight to ten people.
Comfortably. It's a snug you could even share. It's a snug you can make friends.
Yeah, absolutely.
What a place to start.
Snug you could what?
Snug you can make friends.
Yeah, absolutely.
What a place to start snugging.
What a place, and honestly, what a...
It's like, Marcus talks as if he's on Reddit, do you know?
Point as well. Cheers, everyone.
Pints look nice.
Right, where are we going next?
To be continued, and there's your final lie for the night, because as we know, Marcus doesn't continue any of these shitty little series.
And those three were tagging, even though your food looks rotten.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Dirty Dinners!
You're better doing nothing, and I'm not even laughing.
Did you miss Dirty Dinners? It's only like three people that like Dirty Dinners, and one of them is me.
Your photo of a burger looks like there was a murder.
Right, so does anybody have anything cool, funky, fun, and fresh to watch in the break? I would like to let the famous Ying Yang, we haven't had her debut in the Conor G Show yet. I think I would have liked to save her and watch and do a reaction of her on maybe an episode of Conor at Night or something. For some reason, I feel like, you know, just admiring someone's artistry doesn't really suit the Conor G Show, but in Conor at Night, there's less rules and regulations. I don't know. So, but anyway, this girl, Ying Yang, I've been saving her for a rainy day because I know she's bound to impress everyone. So, anytime I feel like I don't have something, I want to just go, let's stick on Ying Yang. But I've just pulled up YouTube here. Dirty Dev's music video has popped up, so I think we're going to play this brand new music video by Dirty Dev's. It's All My Dogs, the official music video, shot by the one and only Skeet89. Whoop, let's get that off there. All right, I'm going to take a very quick break. Yes. When we return, we've got Mashtag Brady is a terrible liar. The rap segment, we got Jed, we got Paul Morris, a bunch of cool, funny, funky guys. All right? It's Dirty Devs. He's got some old school rap thing going on here.
Have you ever been abused? Just been sleeping in the streets. Ever been in the field but having nothing to eat? No place to rest your head, no bed to rest your feet. Uncle Steve,
there's no pool. So sorry, there's Stephen the Loke. All right, going for a wee break. Be right back. Enjoy Dirty Dabs doing his wee thing here. There's a link in the chat.
You ever been abused? Just been sleeping in the streets. Ever been ridiculed for having nothing to eat? No place to rest your head, no bed to rest your feet. Uncle Stevie saved the devs, he took me off of the streets. All my life that I'm on, he wants nothing in return. So I'll operate my hand for every lesson I learned. I want you to know that you're.
you're forever my friend. You're my brother to the end, that's a life and a death. This is for the she always stirring the dance. Always kept me company, the heart of my chest. Think you know the rest, but I gotta confess. He put food up on the plate, now you gotta digest. He put roof up over heads, broke bread with the devs. I can never repay all the things that you did.
Be right back. It's Dirty Devs with Gun to My Head.
Sleeping in the streets, ever been ridiculed for having nothing to eat? No place to rest your head, no bed to rest your feet. Uncle Stevie saved the devs, he took me off of the streets. All my life that I'm on, he wants nothing return. So I offer out my hand for every lesson I learned. I want you to know that you're forever my friend. You're my brother to the end, that's a life and a death. This is for the she always stirred for the devs. Always kept me company, the heart of my chest. Think you know the rest, but I gotta confess. He put food up on the plate, now you gotta digest. He put roof up over heads, broke bread with the devs. I can never repay all the things that you did. I wanna pay you back, I just wanna make amends. I got my life on track, I'll pay the dividend. You know what, keep it real like 110. Every task I've revealed, I'ma do it again. Just know that I love you, I ain't no fucking homo. Trying to stay true, bro, cause this is what I do though. Catch me baby solo, cause I've been feeling solo, waiting on some hope, depending on a halo. Got no fucking angels, been living with these demons, but this is all I got, cause
I don't trust people.
All my dogs, if I say I love you, then I know that it's true. I've been taught to love you from a distance, but I'm breaking the rules. It's like all my dogs, if I say I love you, then I know that it's true. It's like I've been taught to love you from a distance, but I'm breaking the rules. Welcome to my mind, another day in the life. Contemplating suicide and skipping the strife. I'm speaking to the blind, showing death to the saints. Always on the rage, like I'm Jesus Christ. Play the cards I'm given, cause I'll be superstitious. Living with innovation, so mentally imprisoned. Making my mission to get me out of this hole. But all that I can vision is conquering goals. I was raised up from the dirt where my demons be lurking. And search for some victims, know the ones that be hurting. I'm cursed with all the negative thoughts. I see you say those serpents always taking the loss. It broke me to my knees, got me praying to God. Still all I see is evil, ain't no helping this all.
Mr. Serious!
The people, those beginning to fall. Don't do it for the sheep or those who follow along. See, it's empty at the top, but the weak and the strong. And can't be so lonely when you left with your thoughts. My own worst enemy, it has to be taught. It's tragically a fact of me, you're mentally gone. Marching through the fog with the bravery of a demigod. Keeping Hugo like a boss, how we all just get along. Searching for some peace, this is what I seek. This is what I believe and this is what I dream. So this is for the dads, Uncle Steve and Big Ski. They my chosen family, I bleed for them all. Never break the bond. Never break the bond. All my dogs. If I say I love you, then I know that it's true. I've been taught.
He loves his wee mates.
To love you from a distance, but I'm breaking the bridge. It's like all my dogs. If I say I love you, then I know that it's true. It's like I've been taught. But I'm breaking the bridge.
That was the new Dirty Devlin with All My Dogs, filmed at the Fifth Element charity boxing event in courtesy and collaboration with Skank FM. And this is the Conor G Show! Welcome in, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me this evening. Wasn't that nice? Little Dirty Devs. Do you remember he asked me to, like, record a little skit for the intro for his album? He never gave me the script. So look forward to that coming out, whatever that is. The chat's in. Absolutely nothing. Alright, so welcome in, everybody. This is the Conor G Show. Coming up tonight, we have Mashtag Brady is a Terrible Liar, Chad fights the Heathens. We have the freaky freestyle face-off with Emcee Chad Rooeny, RKid and Oisin Crawford making his debut on the ConorG Show. Then we've got... Rockstar responds to Meek N. His brand new diss track has been leaked. And I've been sitting on it for a week, and we're going to be getting into that shortly tonight. Then we also have... Emcee continues his world domination. Strike that. Emcee addresses the allegations. And Paul Morrissey hits a million views. And trains, recovers, then eats. Right, let's get stuck in some Mashtag Brady. Do you know, are you excited for this Rockstar thing here? I hope yous are. Because I've been dying to hear this here. I'm sad it didn't leak before the next show. I don't even know if he recorded it before the show after the one where he played Meek N's song. What a score, says D-Scross of the Wacken Android.
You got the reference?
Do you all know this guy, Mashtag Brady? He's a big famous TikToker. Let's pull up his TikTok account here. Might be good to show you one of his more famous TikToks. So he's mostly known for his TikTokery, but he's recently started posting vlogs to YouTube, which I love because I mostly watch YouTube. And I followed his entire trip through Mexico. He was doing like a wee race with another guy. And I followed the whole thing on his TikTok. He's got like two or three accounts. He's got Mashtag Brady, Mashtag Travels, and then Mashtag Lazy or something. And he's the king of TikTok, right? Nobody can tell him nothing. He's like, he's not like Jed or Geedy. He's just more of like a normal guy. I say normal, I mean complete train wreck of a man, right? So so he's taken his travels over to YouTube, right? And he's such a train wreck of a human being that I was shocked. I didn't think he was going to be able to pull off. He's been posting one vlog a day, about around 20-minute vlog a day at 6 p.m. every single day from his trip to Thailand, right? And, like, I'll tell you, as a professional editor and someone who tried to make vlogs of his trip for the Ko-fi subscribers there, the members over at ConorG.show, that's one of the bonus items you can get, my little vlogs for my margarita tour of the United States. It's difficult doing vlogs, you know, especially to make a good one. You know, he's not a professional editor, but I suppose he is now if he's editing his vlogs and, you know, posting them. The vlogs aren't all that, but it's his personality. It's his, you know, you're invested with his story now. So he started doing these vlogs and he's been posting them every day. He's been proving us all wrong. And I've been thinking, oh, this Mashtag, he's growing up a bit. I can't believe he managed to pull off every vlog a day. I mean, some of them are, you know, not worth uploading, but he's still doing it, right? I want to give him that. So what do we know about Mashtag Brady? He is from Derby in England, right? And when I say a train wreck of a human, he's just one of these people that I believe he has crashed every single car he's ever driven. And he just always seems to have a broken bone or a sprained ankle. His nose is all broken and smashed in. I think he's about 29 years old. Let's just look for the thing I hate about most about him is that he pukes. He's just one of these people. You ever see these people that just puke at everything, right? They eat or drink something knowing it's going to make them puke. Doesn't matter. They just do puke and keep going, right? Here he is. Let me just introduce you to him before we get into the segment tonight, because I've got him doing a blatant lie. All right. Here he is.
Road in Bangkok in Thailand, and I'm about to eat a fucking spider. Oh god. It's not as dry as everything else.
Why are you putting the whole thing in?
It's me! No, I promise you. It's really not that bad. That tastes alright. I mean, I wouldn't eat it. I wouldn't pick it on a menu. It's not better than a fucking chicken nugget from fucking McDonald's.
I hate this bloke says stuck in me off. Why would you want to do that to yourself?
But I tell you what, it's actually...
Disgusting.
It's actually not bad. With a beer, you know what I mean? As a bar snack.
So, yeah, I like these vlogs. I think to be able to be a good vlogger, you have to be sort of a train wreck type of person. You sort of have to, you sort of just have to go with the flow and you not have any social anxiety, which is like, I always like guys like Harold Balder and Balden Bankrupts, because you're just like wandering around filming yourself talking. It's very embarrassing, right? And, so like Harold, he's like unfunny, dorky kind of guy, but he has all the confidence and really doesn't care how stupid he looks and all. But then you've got Mashtag Brady, who he's a bit more socially aware, he's a bit more with it, but he just doesn't care. He just bumps, crashes through life. And it's like, I watch his vlogs and it's like he's aware of the consequences of the things he does. It's just that he doesn't care, right? He's willing, like, you look at his hands are all arthritic and bashed up, and his nose is all smashed. It's like a train wreck, a car crash of a man is the perfect way to describe him. But, so I've been watching him, I'm thinking, oh, he's kind of a good bloke, you know, for a TikToker. I was just like, he doesn't really do, like, shitty things, you know, like, you know, there's all these TikTok pranksters and all those type of people that are just go about day-to-day life being, you know, shitty people, you know, thinking that their actions won't have any consequences. He's not evil or bad in that way, you know, like, I don't know any of the wee guy's names. You know, the guy that walks around with his security, like, bumping into people on purpose so his security will whack him. He's not like that. He's not, do you remember that guy, Jack Jones? He's not like that type of character. You know, he's not like an evil character. He seems sound. And, you know, when you sort of watch him, you're sort of hoping that he's just going to prove himself to not be an arsehole. But there are wee glimpses of it that just poke through. Like stuff like littering, puking in a bar, and just like, it's like puking repeatedly in someone's bar. You know what I mean? It's not cool to do, you know what I mean? Stuff like drink driving, which I believe he does all the time, and he sort of kind of hides it, but not really in his vlogs. One of the things I recommend watching on his YouTube vlogs is he had the little GoPro strapped on him, and he's flying through traffic, and it's like, I was like glued to it. He was like, oh, I realized I forgot to edit that bit. He just like left in his entire motorbike journey through Bangkok. And it was like, that was the most interesting thing he's posted so far, because you can see he's taking real risks. He's putting other people's lives in danger. And that was like riveting to watch. Duck Mio wants to see what this thing is he's eating here. Let's take a look. This is when he was in Belize. So I pretty much, I'm this guy's biggest fan, right? I'm saying this from a place of... Today's vlog, I was just like, oh my god, I have to put this in the show. Or was it yesterday's vlog, maybe? Right, yeah. So I have to introduce Mashtag Brady to the Conor G show here.
I've got two, one for my man over there. Fucking 30 degrees, it's currently 10 a.m.
He thinks it's going to be like a breakfast roti or something.
So hungover,
terrible angle. This is the same angle that Yo Mathman has been playing, or has been doing for his social media weekly weapons, I think he calls his little music introducing series.
We're gonna get an hour bus, an hour fucking boat, and I've got to go and get a fucking...
Let's get to the food here, we're all bacon hungry. Bacon and egg. That's his bacon and egg roti or whatever.
One piece.
That's exactly the look at this.
You fucking
I'm about to took this back just now.
Bro. I've been scammed basically, but I'm not bothered. There's no ketchup.
And right watch there. How he eats.
I'm not to blame for his stuff. He went up there, did his own island.
He goes to McDonald's in every country, which I think is fascinating.
Shit's balls.
There you go. Right, so I don't know. This was a last minute addition to the show. I hope it's all right. So I just want to show you Mashtag Brady. He's been doing his vlogs. He's been riding high. He's been killing the game on TikTok. He's new to YouTube, but his YouTube vlogs are doing really well. Check it out. It's Mashtag Brady's YouTube vlog. He has rented a jet ski, and I've got a few time codes here. So the title of this video is Don't Fall for This The title of this video is Don't Fall for This Jet Ski Scam in Thailand.
Day 18, I'm in Koh Phangan. Let's get straight.
Yay! So as you can see there, he did hit this guy's jet ski, so straight away.
Koh Phangan, let's get straight.
Yeah! See that face there? That's because he bumped into this guy who's filming him. So let's go ahead to 6:20, right? So don't fall for this jet ski scam in Thailand. Let's go to 6:20, see what happens up here. Mashtag. You're letting us down, Mashtag. I had such high hopes for you to be Harold Balder's replacement.
Hey, let's go see the damage on the jet ski, bro.
So let's go see the damage on the jet ski, meaning how much is it going to cost to rent one here?
There's going to be some damage on the jet ski when I'm finished with it anyway.
There's going to be some damage on the jet ski when I'm finished on it anyway, he says. Right, let's skip to 7:26.
Yeah, two jet skis for 20 minutes, special price.
Oh, for me, it's only expensive.
Only expensive? No.
So he's demanding a special price. He's demanding a good deal on this bike.
We'll do 3,500 for 20 minutes each.
So 1,750. 1,750.
Paperwork out.
Yeah. And here he types in, you can't see that there, sorry. Here he's typing in a fake name, his handle, his TikTok, YouTube handle, Mashtag.
You say yes or no? Yeah, he's getting the paperwork out. Yeah.
So there he is, committing fraud. Oops, sorry about that. And there's the jet ski there. So you can see no scratches or anything on it. So let's skip ahead to 8:33.
I wait for you.
Yeah, we'll be back. I just got to get the money and some drink.
I just got to go get some money and some drink, right? He tells the guy, I'm going to go get some drink. So skip ahead to 9:24. He's liking this introduction to Mashtag. Here he is cracking a beer for him and Reggie. Reggie's this wee boy who he met in Koh Phangan. Cheers, as he downs a liter of Chang.
The sidecar, look. Wallace and Gromit.
Yeah.
Wallace and Gromit. Oh, sorry, brother.
All right, then, let's flip ahead to 10:30.
Okay, brother man. That's some money, don't you? What's the, how much do I have to pay if I crash?
Oh, no.
How much do I have to pay if I crash? He's putting it out there. He's saying to this guy for the second time, things may get ugly. Now, remember, he crashes every car he's ever driven. He's broken many bones from crashing. And his last trip across Mexico, crashed moped.
Damage repair, minimum 15, maximum 80.
Yeah.
Maximum 80, okay.
Yeah. So he's like, oh, I only have to pay 80? And then he thinks about it for a second.
It's 80,000. Like grand, isn't it? Grand.
So he's thinking, can I crash this jet ski for content?
Everyone like this video. If we get 1,000 likes, I'll crash into him and write off both of the moped.
So he's shouting that in front of the guy that owns the jet skis. And he's so used to crashing mopeds, he calls the jet skis mopeds.
Nah,
you got
really
a giant ocean. There's no way you're going to crash into anything unless you're trying to crash into something, son.
Gonna crash. I mean, I'm hoping not to crash, to be honest with you.
Not
I don't really fancy paying a grand. Nah, we're not really gonna crash.
We're not really gonna crash. You certainly talk about crashing a lot, Brady. Or Mashtag, as you fraudulently wrote in that form.
Not the crash, to be honest with you.
This guy's made for banged up abroad. It has crossed my mind more than once watching his content. He's either going to end up dead or in jail in one of these countries where they're just not going to find his cheeky, chappy attitude cute anymore.
I don't really fancy paying a grand. Anyway, right, cut to me on a jet ski, Dan.
So cut to me on a jet ski. Here he goes, blasting off.
No, I said these are quick.
There you go.
Oh, shit.
And there at 11 minutes, 17 seconds, he crashes the jet ski.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Quick. Yeah, bad quick. Mine feels right.
We got to skip there. Watch him crash the jet ski right here.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No, I said these are quick. Oh, shit.
Crashes the jet ski. That's it. Crashed. That's it, officially crashed. Let's skip ahead here for a wee second. So look at the way he sits in this jet ski here. Look at him sitting on that. There he is, torturing a poor kayaker. Torturing him, right, so there's the bit where he's obviously just banged into him. With the look on his face here, you can tell he is just banged into this jet ski once again. Look at that face. That is the face of a man who has just crashed a jet ski. Again, for the second time. And here we go. There's Mashtag right there. He's already pulled in, so it's his mate Reggie with the camera right now. And watch what Reggie does. They're trying to say I broke the boat. He squeals from the waves.
You broke it.
And Reggie crashes directly into another jet ski.
Mate, I've rubbed it off.
So here it is, he's got a scratch here and a scratch here, and he's saying, mate, I've rubbed it off, as he pathetically attempts to wipe the scratch. So there were three crashes in total in this. This is after drinking a minimum a liter of Chang.
I'm not paying 400 quid for that!
I'm not paying 400 quid for that!
Give me a good price for this.
Give me a good price for this.
Okay, so how much does that scratch cost? A very baby scratch. It's very, very small.
Listen.
I'm...
Yes, my friend, come back. Come here, you. Speak you, my friend. Yeah.
So his friend's going to come back to speak to you. His friend speaks better English.
Yeah, after this, you are Bangalore. After you no pay, okay, call police. You're going to talk police.
After you no pay, we call the police, okay. Mashtag doesn't want to hear those words. And play.
Listen.
No, why are you threatening me with the police when I haven't done anything wrong, bro? I've not said I'm not going to pay. Yeah. I didn't say I wasn't.
Well, you were drink driving and you crashed his jet ski on purpose, I'm pretty sure.
I'm going to pay.
No.
So don't
After telling him you were going to crash tag Brady, they should call him.
The police when I haven't done anything wrong, bro. I've not said I'm not going to pay. Yeah. I didn't say I
was. Backed into a corner, foaming at the mouth like a rabid beast.
I wasn't going to pay.
No.
So don't threaten me with the police.
No.
You deserve to be threatened with the police. You've been drink driving and crashing the man's jet ski. Breateth. Lock him up! Off with his head! Look, I love his pathetic attempts to wipe it.
Basically brand new.
What do I Basically mean? Brand new, right? So there's a bit here. I think this is it coming up now. This is the most childish attempt to cover his ass. This is, like, worse than what a little kid would say to cover up their mistake, their bad behavior. Listen to this for a little kid's lie.
No.
Basically brand new. What do I owe you for that tiny little baby scratch?
That you make accident, you
know? No. I don't know what I've done. Bro, the scratch is this big.
Yeah,
this big. I don't know what I've done. No? I don't know.
Sorry, I paused at right the wrong time there. I don't know what I've done.
I don't know. Must be some rock in the water. Fly up.
What?
Must be some rock in the water. Fly up.
Oh.
Brady, I know you've just been in the ocean, but your pants are on fire, mate. I mean, that is the worst lie that I've ever heard. Let's hear that lie one more time here. He's like, tiny little baby scratches, multiple scratches from the crashes, from the drunken crashes.
Big, I don't know what I've done.
I don't know what I've done.
There must be some rock in the water. Fly up.
What rock in the water? That's odd.
What rock in the water? Stupid! Says the guy in Thailand.
He's like, ugh.
You're calling me out of my bullshit lie? Ugh. Spoiled rat.
What rock in the water? That's odd.
What rock in the water? It's the ocean, pal. There are no jutting rocks out here.
Rock in the water. Fly up.
What rock in the water? That's
on. He like looks away and he's like, you've been called out here. The Thai guy is speaking better English than him, says Rareway. That's true. Look at him looking down the camera.
I'm dealing with this guy.
I'm dealing with the guy that doesn't speak English. That's what he's saying. He thinks, look, you've just been called out by this guy. Don't be like, you're not making a sale. You're not selling a Chrome Hearts watch here. You can deal with them, two of them. Deal with his translator, Brady. You ignorant swine, yeah.
But we just talk only, you know, you crap, but we don't want money.
You don't want money, bro. Yeah. I don't.
So he just says, I don't want money.
I don't know what I've hit, bro. But obviously it's this big, so it could be anything.
I don't know what I've hit, bro. It's this big, so it could be anything. Probably the crash that you filmed.
You don't want money.
Okay. Huh? I appreciate that. We're good. Okay.
So look at him. Furious, angry jet ski salesman man forced into a friendly handshake. Now, this is edited very strange because there's a Barney and then it cuts to him going, we don't want money. And then he's like, good, okay, shake hand.
Okay. I appreciate that. We're good.
Okay. Yeah. He's just thinking, if I had a knife, you would be stabbed multiple times.
Okay, thank you, brother. Appreciate you. Right, just smoked him at Paul. I'm just going to go grab the bikes.
And then it cuts. There's no recap. There's no, like, oh, did you see what just happened there? They tried to scam us. He just moves on. He just says, oh, I just smoked him at pool. It's like, sorry, what happened there? Did you pull the I'm a famous influencer here on those guys? Because it looks like you might have just pulled the I'm a famous influencer card on these hardworking Joes. These normal working guys. So, right. We all watched that video. He was clearly drinking. He clearly crashed the jet ski, right? Clearly. Like, that's not up for dispute. Those are the facts. Yet he has titled it, Don't Fall for This Jet Ski Scam. You drunk driving and crashing a jet ski into the only thing in the ocean. Here's why he thought he could get away with this, because I took a bunch of screenshots of the comments, right? And they all just bought this. They all just ate this up here. You know, let's crop that down like that. This guy says, Kevob says, I find the editing interesting in that jet ski scene. All good cruising, cut to you off the jet ski complaining about paying for a repair. 10 years ago, they would have forced you into paying. They can't afford the bad press and social media. Luckily, you were filming. Yep, I fell for this. What did you fall for? I fell for this 15 years ago in Pattaya and got frog marched to a hotel to hand over a few bat scumbags. Full moon party video tomorrow. Out gets pissed, deletes footage. That actually did happen, by the way. Lucky with the jet ski, bro. You'd be fighting 20 jet ski lads if that situation happened on a Patong beach, Phuket. You mean crashing your jet ski on purpose for video content and then the guy letting you off with it? The complete opposite of what they're trying to say happened. Luckily for us, it's all recorded on video. They noticed the camera. If not, you'd be saturation, you mentioned. Humble Wordsmith says, I've always been told you have to film the apartment slash car, moped, etc. before you use it. Get all angles, then pay to use it. Ignore the part where he filmed himself crashing it, though, and drinking a beer. It is a known scam on the island. You got away from the scammers. Well done. Well, see, in this instance, there's video. He snitched on himself here. He's a tight. He is a tight. Filmed himself, filmed his crime, posted it to the internet. Well done. Keep the content coming. Amazing vlogs. And real. That's why I like them. Because up until this point, they have been pretty real. Pretty good. Not now. Was bound to get scammed on jet skis. Seen so many vids about them scammers. It's a shame that this one isn't about the scammers. That's the reason they let him off. They saw he was filming. Well, they let him off, I'm pretty sure, because of the kindness of their heart. Jet ski rental owners hit him with this one tip. This is Rare Witch. They did not let him off. He really crashed the jet ski. We finally got an ally here. Why would they let him off? He must have edited out the payment. I mean, something happened there that he did edit out, clearly. He filmed that whole interaction and posted a tiny little segment of it. In the video, they literally said they didn't want money from him. Yeah, something weird happened. Right, well, I'm going to post this to social media. Or something. Obviously, we are speculating.
You do a line and I'll do a line, honey.
Couple more here. Bro, you should always take a video of bikes, jet skis when you rent them. Scratch could have been there already. I own a jet ski, and our rules is even if you're pissed, stay 2 meters away from each other. Stop what you did happening, but in all honesty, you could have 100% avoided hitting the other jet ski. Lol. Thank you. At least there's a few honest people in here. Always 3000 says, damn, the Thailand damaged jet ski scam is in full swing. Lol. Not in this video. This isn't an example of that. I remember one of my Marines went to jail because of this. That scratch was there already, obviously. It wasn't obvious. He crashed it. Drunk crashed it. But they paint over it with some cheap paint, and then the jet ski gets wet. It washes away. Then voila. When Guardian Levy, you're so effed. You're effed, but it's only because you've lost a slight bit of credibility there. Alright, that was Mashtag lying, cheating, scheming, and drunk driving his way across Thailand. Alright, this is the Conor G Show. This is the celebrity section. Let's get stuck into some Jed before we get into our local rapper segment. Our local rappers tonight are Emcee Chad Rooeny, RKid, and Oisin Crawford making his debut on the Conor G Show. Then, Rockstar RESPONDS! Rockstar RESPONDS to Meek Mill! Meek Mill, Meek N. Emcee continues his world domination. Actually, he addresses the allegations. And we've got Paul Morrissey. Train recover 8. Oh yeah, we got a little drawing here we need to do. Let's see. We have Ducky Mia redeemed. A little drawing of Mashtag, I believe. Excuse me. Ball bag Brady, they should call him, says Rare Wish. Rare Wish. Hammond says, Brits abroad, yikes. Ducky Mia says, Mashtag with the hair of the one from the Primitives picture in Discord. Oh, I hate a Discord reference from Ducky Mia. Not going to get mad about it, though. She doesn't deserve that. In a Discord. This is possibly the worst reference I've ever heard of.
You got the reference?
Okay, open in browser. This is let's see what duck email is going on right here. This person. Just a lady here. An innocent lady being dragged into this for no good reason. Did any of these people watch the same video, says Rare Witch? I think they all have had lobotomy, says Ducky Meow. Steve Mann says, Justin from work and Jed made an appearance. He's coming up soon. He's coming up next after we do this wee drawing here. An act of God. Jed coming up next just as Steve Mann enters. Let's see. The song Crash. Come on, she says. I don't have the energy to battle with you. So what's the drawing here? Spell us out for me. Spell us out for me while I have a wee rest. Just getting some energy drink here. Come on, give me this direction here. Mashtag with the hair of the one from the primitives. Right, okay. So the song's called Crash. Because he said crash loads of times. Yeah, I pieced that together there. Just pieced that together there. I'll do the wee drawing right now. Well, I need to get a picture up of his face, actually. This song is TC Crew, Welcome to the Underground. Let's do this little drawing here. The Mashtag. Handsome man, this Mashtag, right? Starting to feel the heat now. Screaming and shouting, trying to introduce new guys to your show. What do you do? Is like Mashtag? Should we keep up to date? Make sure he's not committing any more crimes? Do you not know this song? Says Ducky Mia. Yeah, it's like a popular classic pop song. Right? Crash, shout, let it all out. These are the things you can do without. Come on, right?
J18, I'm in code man.
There's gonna be some damage on a jet ski, but I'm finished with it anyway.
He says, no. That guy's a great A wanker, says Rob. I thought he was signed. I thought he was signed up until this latest escapade. This is the first inkling that I've had that he is not a great guy. Alright, so we've got our little reference images here. There's a little reference images. What do you like watching the drawing take place, or do you like the big reveal? I'm not sure. All right, here we go. This is a little drawing redeemed by the famous Ducky Mia. Oh, we've run out of song already. All right, this next one is Juvon with Be Free, the instrumental mix. Yeah, I'm supposed to do the hair. What was the song you were on about talking about? Here in my crash, I feel safest of all. And I open the door and I crash my car in cars. Not any song. Magical drawing of Mashtag Brady as that lady. From Crash. From the Primitives. I axed that song out already, didn't I? Get it? Because he crashes a lot, says she. He's a good one to draw. I imagine I'll be drawing a lot more of him. The Channel Point Maniac, Duckle Meal. Right. Wasn't that lovely? All right, this is the ConorG Show. Right now, we are continuing the celebrity section with Jed Fights the Heathens. So remember last week, we spoke about Jed and his holiness, his holy love for the Lord. If you've missed out on last week's show, you can get the entire episode on ConorG.show. You chip in there, support the ConorG Show, get rewarded with every other episode, which is going to be behind the paywall. So I'll be posting a clip from that last week's show of Jed battling the heathens. And I was giving him encouragement and some tough love. I was suggesting that it wasn't so much for me the fact that he loves God and celebrates Jesus online. It's how he does it comes across as demonic, demented, blasphemous, crazy, whatever. So I just trying to steer him in the right direction there. And will it work? Absolutely not. So the reason that I decided to clip that and post it on YouTube was Jed's girlfriend. Jed's girlfriend got in touch recently, and let's see what she said. So there's a lot of rumors and innuendo going around that the reason that Jed has become so Christianized is because he's got this girlfriend and she's religious. Okay, so I obviously don't know that. I don't know that for to be the case. That's what people are saying. That's just what people are saying.
You do a line and I'll do a line, honey.
So, let me see here. Let's see if we got what she actually said. I'm not going to say her name. That's why I'm not pulling it up on screen. We're very forgiving. We're very kind to the characters that appear on my screen. We don't like to drag their girlfriends into it. Even though she is a character on social media. She appears in his videos, appears in his social media and stuff. I just don't see the need to bring her up on this here show. But she did leave me a message. So, I posted a little video. It was just a little quick edit of me poking some fun at Jed during his little speaking in tongues outburst here. It went a little something like this. So this is a clip from last week, and I'll be posting a longer clip because we have got Jed's girlfriend's blessing on that.
Jesus. I've experienced.
Jed.
You're upset about.
You are my brother in Christ.
You talking about.
You've converted me. I have been saved. I have been converted right in front of your eyes. I have ascended. So that just on TikTok, that loops nicely. That just keeps looping like that. So that's what I posted to TikTok. And to me, that's kind of like a very mild thing because he is like acting weird. You know, it's not my usual half hour long breaking down every word out of his mouth type vid. That was just a very silly one, right? So Jed's girlfriend got in touch. Oh, no, I've lost it now. Jed's girlfriend got in touch and she said, "The guy only gets views when he puts other people down. Sad to see." And I was so honored that Jed's spirit guide, / girlfriend, got in touch that I asked her, because knowing that the episode was behind the paywall, should I post the full clip where I'm defending Jed and his faith? And she said, "I would love to see that." Just make sure she did say that. I don't even know if I have a screenshot. She said, "I would love to see that," or something like that. So she has given the blessing. I've done no editing to the clip apart from speeding up a little time lapse of a drawing we did of him at the end. That's going to be dropping on YouTube any day now. And you'll see the hilarious thumbnail that I made for it as well. So that's just a little video of me defending Jed / God. So after that debacle of that wee lad, Dara, that little pipsqueak, having a go at Jed for sharing his love of God with the world, Jed has doubled down. Jed's doubled down. He's come back with another smash hit renegade worship clip. And seeing as this is Jed's message, I think it's important that we hear this. Now, what else did I want to say? I don't have any notes for this here. I didn't want to come preloaded with any preconceived notions, but
you do a line and I'll do a line, honey.
So, the thing that alarms people isn't that Jed's religious, right? I don't know if Jed knows that. It's the way he's doing it. It's the ferocity with which he is delivering the Lord's message that frightens people. It's not the fact that he loves God. I mean, as I said, that's pretty much the greatest thing that has ever happened to me, is Jed having something. Don't get me off, has redeemed the Be Nice Challenge. We don't need to redeem the Be Nice Challenge. Well, yeah, fair enough. Right, so how do I find a nice way to say this? So the strength, okay, it's the Be Nice Challenge. Don't be mean. the strength and honor, the strength that Jed has to defend God's honor is inspiring. The only thing Gibberish has redeemed voodoo, a voodoo curse against Jed. Now, as some of you may have witnessed last week, I stopped this voodoo curse dead in its tracks. And Rare Witch did not get his channel points back. Those are God's channel points now. I was cracking myself up at that line. You're not getting those channel points back. Do not refund Rare Witch. He knows I'm not going to put a curse on Jed, especially when we're in the middle of the Be Nice Challenge. You've just squandered 6,000 channel points trying to put a comedy pox on Jed. Pretty sure the creator doesn't need Jed standing up for him, says Rob. No, of course not. So, right, this is going to be very difficult because I was just going to make a quick point here. Now I got to be super duper nice about it. So everyone thinks Jed's gay. Is that, how do I say this by being nice? Everyone thinks Jed's gay. And he's mentioned several times on his Instagram that his girlfriend is the one that pursued him. So what people are saying, not me, it's none of my business. I'm here to defend Jed and Jed's faith and the direction he would like to go in. Seems like all the God stuff might be covering up for the fact he's trying to just keep this thing that he doesn't want getting out. He's trying to stifle it down. Everybody knows what religious people think about gay people. Back myself in the very bad corner here. Jed, stop explaining yourself to strangers online. Be who you want to be. Gay, straight, religious, homophobic. Doesn't matter. I'm not saying he is those things. Be who you want to be. Spread your wings and fly. In the face of adversity, stand up for what is right. I don't know. I was sort of kind of like flogging a dead horse with Jed because every time I want to just like pull up one of his funny videos and make fun of it, tease him a little bit, make fun of it. I think that's what adults do, right? You can make fun of something without being pressed or without hating or being jealous. You're just making fun of something silly online. It's that simple. And that's where my heart lies. And I feel like Jed, especially someone who seems as lost as him, might need some sort of guidance, but he doesn't. My delivery will never get through to him because it's so cheeky. It just will not. Rob says, okay, let me just turn on my gaydar and I'll be honest. He's not pinging, says Rob. So you're saying he's straight. There you go. I've got a gay Christian in the chat. He's saying Jed is a straight Christian. Yeah, so there are beard allegations. There are conversion therapy allegations. And it's this whatever sect he is a part of. None of this is, I don't know anything what I'm talking about. These are rumors that are floating around, right? These are just what people are saying. I'm just saying this to give the viewer the full context. As if we need that. There are these, like, you got your prods, you got your Catholics, you got your Muslims, Buddhists, Hindus, Sikhs. All the best religions. And then you got these wee offshoots, which I shudder to name any of them. But I don't know what denominatio, what Dalmatian Jed's is. But it's whenever people start coming out with all this, with these speeches about, you know, God and stuff, and you know what I'm talking about, that's when it starts to get a wee bit creepy. And like, those are the people that who I've heard, you know, talk about the evils of certain lifestyle choices. And he's already started with the alcohol and clubbing, the evils of that, which I think maybe he talks about here. But you know what the next step on is from that? Denouncing gays. Now, I don't know that he's going to do that, but historically, through this type of religious rhetoric, all right, I think I've made my point, so let's continue on with this video.
Are we seriously going to sit around and justify alcoholism? Like, how are we
going? Are we seriously going to sit around and justify alcoholism? Okay, we're in the Be Nice Challenge, so I retract that statement.
Don't be mean, don't be mean.
This Black Studios comment says, it's not a sin. People pick up something to deal with past trauma. Making a devil out of the drink is fear-based. Being drunk on Jesus is the same as escapism. Facing ourselves takes time and compass.
Here's my message to you Oxers.
Let's see what the chat are saying here before we get stuck into this little vid. I do not want to spend a long time on this. We've got lots of local rappers coming up, and you know, we might have to postpone Paul Morrissey again. That's how it's looking. I'm desperate to get in some Paul Morrissey. Wasted so much time in Dirty Dinners. let's see. what song were we playing for this? Oh yeah.
Don't be mean, don't be mean. Don't be mean, don't be mean. Don't be mean, keep it clean.
Steve Mann says, has he ever stated what his church's views are on the gay community? He knows that would be career suicide if he ever did state that. And if it's they don't care, then hopefully he will address that also.
Don't be mean, don't be mean.
It's on the shankle, so I'm gonna say the views are not great.
Don't be mean.
You do a line.
I'm getting pretty scared now. He doesn't read gay to me, just narcissistic, says Rob. Investigation cam on the new generation of family church. Oh, no, 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 no. I can't do this. I can't be the one to do this. We're in the middle of the Be Nice Challenge. Which is it? Be Nice Challenge or investigate his church? Make up your mind, you freaks. Let the man be happy. That's what people are saying on my TikTok. Let him be happy. They saw that Jesus video and they're like, they take that as hate. A smiled teasing compared to what just happened here. This just normal human discussion.
Don't be mean, don't be mean.
Broad track, the next generation, says Rob. Watching Connor trying to tiptoe this is hilarious. Steven says, thought as much, but I don't think he can say it in case Brand stopped working with him. No, he could never. He could never. He would never. And I don't think he's like that. I think he is. There are some people who are just don't like the idea of being gay, and they just decide to stay in the closet their entire lives, and they get wives and all, and the wives know, they just play along because they love their husband. It's what happens in life. You gonna judge him for being gay now as well as being Christian? Because that's not what the Conor G Show does. We judge people for silly haircuts, funny voices, and cringe social media trends. Not that other serious stuff, or what some people might find serious. He started on the evils of a penty, if I remember correctly. We touched on that last week. He moved out of the penty because he didn't want to drink, and his next video was him going to the club. I believe we're going to check out these comments, but that's what people are saying. It's giving cult to listen to his background music. Postpone the rappers. We need our Paul fix. Rob, there would be mutiny on the bounty if people didn't hear this Rockstar feature. Although I would like to do that to wind up Meek N a little bit. Let's see. investigate the church, they're saying. They're about to have a YouTube. I guess he's going to set it up for them for free. They don't have normal Anglican churches in Northern Ireland. No gay man would wear that jacket, says Rob. All right. We can't investigate the church. Leave the man's church alone. Leave his girlfriend alone. Leave the church alone. And leave Gidi alone. We're not making fun of anything. Don't be mean. Keep it clean. Watch this.
Into a place in society where we're going to enable people to have destructive habits just because it's advice for them to turn to whenever they feel low. Even if you want to take away the fact that being drunk keeps...
Okay, so, yeah. Christianity aside, sexuality aside, views on gays aside. Jed's videos are always really patronizing. I think that's we're coming to an understanding. The more we watch Jed, we're figuring out what is triggers people about him. He's patronizing. He's incredibly condescending. We can work on that together. We can work on that together, Jed. But identifying the root of the issue is where we need to begin before we can take steps to fixing your social media presence. They call me the damage control expert. They call me the fixer. I burn the house down and then I rebuild it brick by brick from the foundation. Kind of like what Giddy does with people's social media brands. Oh yeah, so and it's incredibly patronizing to suddenly start going to church and then quickly start dictating to people the rights and wrongs and evils of something that you've been doing for many years. Give it a wee minute or two, Jed. Live the life for more than a fortnight before you start preaching from the pulpit. This is all meant in a... I'm delivering my sermon from the mount as big brotherly advice. Jed needs to hear that and he needs to believe it.
Mea culpa, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There's a video in the chat. Ducky Mio might want to... Is this the thing of his... Is this the is this video of Jed's church? No, we're not church doxing him. I'm not interested. If he says it on his social media, we'll talk about it, but I'm not church doxing him. He probably has said it because that's how you were able to find it, but no, I don't want to do that. See, I'm not evil, Jed. Booziness is next to godliness, and you'd know.
It's advice for them to turn to whenever they feel low. Even if you want to take away the fact that being drunk keeps you away from God, it's still a spiritually, emotionally, and physically damaging thing to be doing to your body.
The only time I pray is when I'm hammered drunk. The main time I talk to God is the day after.
Like, we are so far gone that we think it's okay to...
Jesus Christ, I never fucking drink. Yeah, Jesus God, please make the pain go away. Like that.
Put our faith in the alcohol to save us rather than putting our faith in Jesus Christ.
So sometimes he says faith, sometimes he says faith. He chooses when he's going to use that VF that people from Belfast sometimes use.
Of course, alcohol is advised to people to pick up, but that doesn't mean that we should enable it. My granddad was an alcoholic and it broke my heart 3 months ago when he died. Not even necessary that he passed.
Tugging on the heartstrings.
Because he died brokenhearted. It was what happened in his past life.
Okay, I don't think it's right to bring up dead relatives to illustrate a slam dunk on a TikTok comment. Call me a jealous hater. I don't think that's cool to do. But of course, these are your own lived experiences, Jed, and I'm here to listen.
That led him to the drink, and not only did that drink hurt him physically in the sense that he had bad organs because of the alcohol, but also because the drink kept him away from his family and it was making him do bad things, because that is what alcohol does. It is evil. You're saying making a devil out of the drink is fear-based? Well, it should be, of course. Nothing good comes from it except for that momentary high. But what if I told you that momentary high can last eternally? through one man. God gave you the gift of free will to be able to do whatever it is you please. So I'm not going to tell you what to do, but I'm just simply asking you to weigh up the options. I just wish I got saved not just 2 months ago, but years ago, so that I could tell my granddad about the goodness of God. You aren't made to carry the weight of the world on your shoulders, and you don't have to turn to destructive habits to get through tough situations. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26, Jesus says, this is impossible. But with God,
look, he's got his hand on his cacks.
Things are possible. As someone that has suffered deeply with mental health problems ever since I accepted Jesus.
Don't make fun of me. I got mental health problems.
Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. I've experienced the peace like nothing else.
That's why it's important to let him have God.
Crazy how we experience all these problems in our life and we run and chase our tails in circles trying to find an answer for those problems. But little do we know, it was sitting staring at us in the face the entire time. Of the alcohol, but also because the drink kept him away from his family and it was making him do bad things, because that is what alcohol does.
In an effort to understand Jed, Conor sat and watched the same video for 3 hours on a live broadcast. Doctors tried to force entry into his home, but they could not break through the door. In the end, a SWAT team had to be sent to smash through the window and drag him away from the computer screen as he entered an evangelical trance while staring at Jed's teeth.
It is evil. You're saying making a devil out of the drink is fear-based? Well, it should be, of course. Nothing.
He just pulled an Emcee hand. So Emcee has adopted this. This is now the Emcee move. He just did it, though.
Making a devil out of the drink is fear-based. Well, it should
be. Oh, no,
it's
a thumb. I got it wrong there.
From it except for that momentary high. But what if I told you that momentary high can last eternally through one man? God gave you the gift of free will to be able to do whatever it is you please. So I'm not going to tell you what to do, but I'm just simply asking you to weigh up the options. I just wish I got saved not just 2 months ago, but years ago, so that I could tell my granddad about the goodness of God. You aren't made.
I wish that, too. I wish that happened for Jed. Well, luckily for Jed, you will be able to meet your grandfather again one day in heaven.
They carry the weight of the world on your shoulders, and you don't have to turn to destructive.
Jed is a professional videographer, by the way. This is not a good look for a sermon.
Habits to get through tough situations.
This is, I mean, it's so frightening. It's so frightening. I mean, we're doing the Be Nice Challenge here. That's why I'm not commenting too much, but I don't have much to say. I've already made my point clear when it comes to Jed. It's just, he's so rich. He's such a rich character now. You know what I mean? If only he was able to take the slaggins a bit more and a bit more good natured, it would be easier to like him. You know what I mean? Okay, we've got a prediction here. By Disgrace of the Week and Android, he says, Jed going back on the drink this year. All right, let's put that prediction on the board. The roof is wrong. All right, welcome in Jakku. She says, sounds like he needed therapy, not religion. New self-help book coming soon, I think, or a 6-week program. His own detox clinic, maybe. Excellent. We're gonna put that in as well. We're gonna put that as a prediction as well, Jakku. I did a prediction first, says Rob. Bitch, you little Rob. Okay, let's see. We've got multiple predictions here. Jed burns through being Christian by time Christmas comes around. Okay, so we'll do a triple predict here. This one is saltwater fish, so the Pesce mix.
There's the picture of Jed from last week. Girlfriend has given me the blessing to post that clip online.
Ducky Mail says, this is what happens when you internet too much and don't have good friends. Giddy's a good friend. Gady's a good friend. Yikes, that hurts a lot. Is that music clip from you lot, or is that just me? Right, we're doing a these funny bronzers. M thought it's a shrimp. Bron thought R. Is that guy's name Mikey Menace? No more than him. 2024 predictions. Jed will be back on the drink this year. Back on the drink this year. Jed finishes being a Christian by Christmas. And then what did Jakku say? Let's see. He's going to capitalize off this Christian thing by doing some sort of clinic or program that people pay him to go to. Mr. Johnny Come Lately Christian. I've been just supporting Jesus since the 80s, son. So here's our new predictions. We've got, where's this camera here? We've got, how did I get this on screen? Oh, I'm such a bad broadcaster, aren't I? All right, so we've got Jed back on the drink by Christmas. Jed opens a detox program, and Jed is done with God by Christmas, right? Those are the three predictions here. Congratulations, everybody. Got any? Hey, you've heard this tune before? You've got this plugged into your TV speakers. Right, any hilarious comments in the chat here? Not going to tell you what to do. Proceeds then to tell you what to do. He's only started the Bible. This guy is never reading the Bible, says Rare Witch. Audiobook. The exact same thing just happened to Diddy, says Disgrace. He needs mushroom coffee, says Ducky Mia. The SWAT team busting in his home. Jim Jones, not the rapper. It loses something when he keeps putting cuts in. Well, that's what all our videos are like. All his videos are like. I made a point of doing no editing in my Jed clip. It's about 20 minutes long from last week. That'll be going up tomorrow, the next day, to youtube.com/ConorGShow. Keep an eye out for that, especially if you missed last week's show, which is behind the paywall there at ConorG.show. E for evangelical. This whole thing wants me to throw up, says Ducky Meek N.
Fuck him in. He says, looks like an AA recruitment video. Sir, it definitely does. It definitely does. So that's what Jackie was saying. It'll parlay this into some sort of, you know, group therapy session where you get to hang out with Jed and make TikToks about God as long as you don't get pished. Bro, it says, I can only make sense of this if it's explained to me on Hard Listen Podcast. That didn't last, did it? 3 episodes we got out of that. Alright, so let's check out the comments of this and then let's get on to our local rappers. We're running out of time here tonight. Oh, can I not? I need to be signed in to read the comments? Oh, God, sick. Let me try to sign in here. This will be painless. Here we go. We're loading. Oh, when's my birthday? I'll get lost. What am I gonna log in for? Looks sick. Sorry about this, everyone. I need to go. We're gonna have a quick break before we get into the local rapper section. Sign up. Oh, signing up. I'm logging in. You freak. Already have an account. Log in. Oh, this isn't logging. So sorry, right? That segment is... forcing me to log in. I can't log in. It's forcing me to make a new account. Sorry, we're abandoning it. Home track ID. This one is Saltwater Fish, the Pesce mix. Out to Colin and Waffles on this one. I redeemed a rewind on this and calling out Waffle Stream as he was mixing out of it 1 week. Beautiful little song there. I think you will agree. All right. This is the Conor G Show. Coming up next, we've got the freaky freestyle face-off between Emcee Chad Rooeny, RKid, and Oisin Crawford. Rockstar responds to Meek N. And Emcee addresses the allegations. Well, we're definitely not getting to Paul Morrissey this week, so forget about that. We're 2.5 hours in. I'm taking a very quick break. Stick around. We got all that crack coming up for you in just a moment. We'll be right back.
This one is Bobby Dreams with Creepin'. Welcome back to the ConorG Show. I'm your host, and this is the ConorG Show. Coming up next, it's the local rapper section. They say coming up next, it's the rapper section. Coming up next, it's the local rapper section. Featuring Emcee Chad Rooeny. RKid and Oisin Crawford. As well as Rockstar responds to Meek N. And Emcee addresses the allegations. All right. Right, who will we go for first? The bloody poll isn't working tonight, so I might abandon this here and save the freaky freestyles for next week. Oh, polls work. Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a freaky fresh freestyle from Emcee Chad Rooeny. He's one cool dude, and he raps. Check it out, it's Emcee Chad Rooeny. That's one for fire, two for shite in the chat right now. Oh, no audio. Rewind! This one is Cuckoo Price with Vendetta. He's getting an alt player up here. Welcome in, everybody! It's the Freaky Freestyle Face-Off! Here we go, it's Emcee Chad Rooeny kicking hella fresh flow. Doing a wacko jacko beat. Ducky Mio has redeemed the disclaimer. What? Raw 1210 says, I'm a big fan of RKid. Well, hopefully you'll love this little freaky freestyle here. All right, here we go. It's Emcee Chad Rooeny in the house. Check it out. One for fire, two for shite. I've been screaming and shouting for 3 hours straight. Give me a chance here. Alien Antrim Farm. Smooth Criminal Remix is disgrace. He's a cool dude! Croft says so! Shut the fuck up, lad! Alright, so that's a two from Rob. I am giving this another listen. I like the little beat. I like this smooth criminal beat. I like how they've trapicized it. Emcee Chad Rooeny, friend of the ConorG Show. No Chad slander. He looks extremely stoned out. See, when I was like 14, I thought it was so cool to look stoned out. Now that I'm older, when you see someone that's stoned out, you just think, get it together. But I do think it's a good look to be smoking a spliff during a freestyle. Bad aesthetics there. That's what I meant, Rob. Thank you. Is he lip syncing? Says, look at me. Oh, don't think so. I don't think so. No way. Ha! When you step into Jed Rooney, don't you dare boo me. I'm the kind of G show. Press one for fire. I ain't a liar. Cause I spit the truth when I step in the booth. Sick beat, cool dude, tattoos, spliff, classic bent as far as it'll go, schmick cap. How are you pressing two? That's a one from me, Chad Rooney! Turn it up for Chad!
I never give a fuck about these cars trying to boss me out to get left on the side. I'm rolling with my team crew.
Here's my message to you, Oxford.
So I can't really hear what he's saying too well, but I like how it sounds. I like this. He's a real cool dude here. But I did it on the side.
Call me
out
like a one car, shut the fuck up, light and see. Don't have 5 feet from the cruising of the black boys, blowing on weed and they know we. I never give a fuck about these cars trying to force me out to get left on the side.
Never know about these cunts trying to bust me out, get left on the side. D-Scray says, RKid readying the brush to sweep this face off. Shut the fuck up, MC don't have.
Like a walk on, shut the fuck up, like MC don't have.
Smell a bitch and a noodle to shoot. I'm liking this shot. This is hitting my sweet spot. Rob says, because he's a chav smoking a spliff in a car waving his phone around. What? That's what rappers do, son. Rob's my senior, so I shouldn't say that. Do people try and bust each other out a lot on those roads, says Raw?
About these cars trying to bust me out to get left on the side. I'm going with my team crew when the girls go on and it's time to ride. Trying to call me out like a one car, shut the fuck up, lad. MC don't have.
MC don't have. I'm like this. Alright, Chad. Everybody getting your votes in here?
I never give a fuck about these cars trying to bust me out to get left on the side. I've been rolling with my team crew when the girls go on and it's time to ride.
All right. Right, so that was Emcee Chad Rooney with his wee song with the smooth criminal flow. Nobody liked that except for me. That was good, Chad. Love ya. Love your whole vibe, mate. All right, here we go. Of course, it wouldn't matter if this was a video of RKid or not. He wears a mask. Too afraid to show his fucking face. Not like Chad motherfucking Rooney. All right, one for fire, two for shite in the chat. It's RKid. People are going to vote for RKid because they know him and like him already. Bunch of jealous haters hating on my man, Emcee Chad.
I mean, yo, we'll chop you up to stake a whack of band and then attack your friends when you're on the road and catch a knack in hands. Go with spike, we're cracking backs and then we're whacking heads. Collect them red, moving jackets till the sack and dead.
Sacks and hands, introspection
over lack of feds. I wanna see the end, fuck a sailor land dead. It's our kid, can't blow your fucking eardrums.
Alright, so we rewind on that bad ting. We blessed us with 22 seconds of pure pain on the mic.
We'll chop you up just like a whack of bands. And then attack your friends when you're on the road and catch a knack in hands. Go with spike, we're cracking backs and then we're whacking heads. Collect them red, moving jackets till it's knacking dead.
Hello, my name is RKid. If you did not know, I'm spitting on the mic with a hella fresh flow. I cover my face and you know I don't care. I sell a load of drugs and I sniff a lot of gear. Okay, everyone gets their own inspired by freestyle from me. It's not a promise, it's a guarantee. All right, just pulling a wee pick of them up here. Get this like this. Poll should pop up there, and there we go. All right, it's 66.7% fire. Once more for the people down. It's RKid! The fuck your fresh freestyle! Probably rapping about drugs and crime again.
Yo, we'll chop you up just like a whack of band. And then attack your friends when you're on the road and catch a knack in hands. Go with spike, we're cracking backs and then we're whacking heads. Collect them red, moving jackets till it's knackin' dead.
It's one for me.
Sacks and hands, introspection over lack of feds. I wanna see the end, fuck a sailor and
dead. She says it's fucking shit. And she would batter him if she ever saw him in real life. Here we go, once more for the people in the back.
Yo, we'll chop you up just like a whack of band. And then attack your friends when you're on the road and catch a knack in hands. Go with spike, we're cracking backs and we're whacking heads. Collect them red,
one from
Rod Wild,
one from Atomic Adam. That's a one from W. She's a back.
Sailor 9 dead. It's our kid. Can't blow your fucking eardrums.
Right, okay, there I go. It's RKid, come to blow your flipping eardrops. Can't really hear him, but I'm giving him a one because he's signed. He already gave it a two. You can't give more than one vote, stupid. I'm talking to Meek N there as well. All right, so that was RKid and Emcee Chad Rooeny. Now we've got our final guy here making his debut on the ConorG Show. It's Oisin Crawford. Give it up for Oisin. Always having a wee sip of wee energy drink there. He's a cool dude.
Yo.
He's Mr. Moody.
They always talk about that fake shit, never about that real shit. Been too many lads, it's been lit up in a casket. Every night I'm asking, I beg I make it out. Let me hit, I be thinking, no, I can't even make it out.
Cause one these for fire, two for shit in the chat, right now. Oisin Crawford, he goes by OC Raps.
Every night I'm asking, I beg I make it out. Let me hit, I be thinking, no, I can't even make it out. Cause these thoughts in my mind, man, they're fucking me up, boy. Got these demons in my head, saying I'll never make it out. Got a blunt in my hand, I figure it out.
Smoking
every
weed.
I'm stressing because I can't go avoid. Gotta feed the addiction. I see you pop the prescription. Try to call you up, but you don't want to listen. Sitting in the gaff every night.
What's for fire, two for shad for young Oisin.
Just searching for your vision, but you're too fucked up in this life that you're loving. Feeling so trapped like our heads in a prison. Life's a tough game, got me choked, this submission. Gotta take my shot, man, I shoot with precision.
There you go, that's young Oisin there, ducking me off saying, I did not say that about RKid. That was a two for the previous guy. There's a delay. All the excuses of the day.
Shit balls.
All right, that was Mr. Moody, young Oisin there. It's listening one more time. One for fire, two for shit in the chat. Not a single vote. Come on, everybody. There's a one for these eyebrows at least. Mr. Moody. Moody Man MC, very atmospheric piece. Yo. Here. Oh, look at this in the background. What's this? What's this here that says weed? Is this one of Hyphen's constabulary? Is this what's that? Derry FC. He's one of Hyphen's blood. Bloods, brethren.
They always talk about that fake shit, never about that real shit. Been too
this is very Meek N the style here.
Lad, it's been lit up in a casket. Every night I'm asking, I beg I make it out. Let me hit, I be thinking, no, I can't even make it out. Cause these thoughts in my mind, man, they're fucking me up, boy. Got these demons in my head, saying I'll never make it out. Got a blunt in my hand, I offer
one for fire, two for shite.
Every day I'm
get your voting fingers out of your hole.
Gotta feed the addiction, I see you pop the prescription. Try to call you up, but you don't wanna listen. Sitting in the gaff every night, I know you're wishing that your back comes up. Just searching for your vision.
There's one from Stephen, one from Dugabia, one from Rob. Bless him, he's trying, says Rob.
Like our heads in that prison. Life's a tough game, got me choked, this submission. Gotta take my shot, man, I shoot with precision.
Alright, that was young Oisin there. 100% fire from the shot. Nobody got away with that. Although, the two that was there for RKid, that was an accidental two, she claims. All right, so that was a young Oisin. That was the freaky freeside face-off, and RKid won that one. No point in doing an overall poll, because obviously, right? I really liked MCs. I liked MCs. I don't think he ever sent me that Barbie Girl one that he did with Rich Mix, so that's what I'm really looking forward to. You know that's going to be comedy. Joan Crawford eyebrows is the new thing in the rap game. Is that Lee's mate, that wee lad? All right, ladies and gents. Now for the main event. Rockstar responds to Meek N. Remember if I put this song in the notes here for the night. All right, Meek N diss. Oh God, where did I put it? It should be in the deck so I can play it through the controller here. Stupid.
Me.
Library, refresh library. Yeah, gonna need plenty of wheel ups. Ladies and gentlemen, you witnessed it a few weeks ago, Meek N, last night at the infamous Rockstar, calling him Popstar. Desperately trying to get the people to call Rockstar Popstar. Sending me tons of DMs referring to Rockstar as Popstar as if that's an insult. His name's Rockstar, so calling him Popstar isn't really much of an insult. He would take that. Do you know what I mean? But Meek N, nobody knew he was going to diss Rockstar. I came from left field. And I think some of the people involved in the production might have been the real people who probably had beef with Rockstar. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go on youtube.com/ConorGillespie. Look for a video called The Craig Avon Massacre, Meek N versus Rockstar, where we listen to Meek N's little diss track. And everybody was like, holy shit, what are you dissing Rockstar for? And then what really, as if that wasn't shocking enough, Meek N dissing Rockstar out of the blue. Everybody was confused at who dissed Meek N. It was this guy called Dan, aka Always, on Instagram. He came back and dissed Meek N. He didn't do a diss track against Meek N. He just used a little clip of one of his raps. And then at mentioned Meek N, I guess, and did a little picture of an owl eating a mouse, which, or a rat, which is supposed to be Dan fighting with Meek N. Hilarious little rap beef there. But this confused the world, as last we heard from Dan, he was accusing Rockstar of stealing one of his songs, stalking him through the streets, sending me photographs of Rockstar's car and stuff like this here. And I just didn't do anything with it because it was like, he's saying these guys used to be friends. And I was just like, I don't want to get in the middle of a friendship. Everybody thinks I'm this big evil guy that's out to get everyone. It's not true. I try to protect people. One of those people being Rockstar, even though he has sent me a mountain of veiled threats. I'm that caring and compassionate. And the week after that, we were expecting this diss track to drop from Rockstar, but we heard nothing. And after the show, we heard that Rockstar turned up to the former Hotbox studio, now Devious Studios. And he turned up. Here's what the gossip is, people.
I'm not even here trying to push that weight anymore. Like,
here's what the gossip is. He turned up drunk with a wee girl. And he went into the studio and he recorded his diss track. This is what I heard.
You do a line and out.
Not saying any of this is true. Because a lot of people hate Rockstar. A lot of people hate Rockstar. You just don't know the half of it. I know more than half of it because everybody comes to me as if I'm out to get the guy. Discretion, bro. Yeah, Rockstar sent me voice messages talking about discretion.
You got the reference?
And there's been so many investigations done on Rockstar. We're not talking about all of Rockstar's things. This is about the beef. So he turned up the studio, pished with a wee girl. And he went in the booth and he was struggling to perform the rap. This is what I heard. And he was reading it off his phone, going line by line. This is what the rumors are. I'm not saying this is true. I obviously have no way to verify this. People could make this shit up to set me up and get me in trouble. People do it all the time with me. And the wee girl came in and said, how long are you going to be? And apparently he went mental and made her stand outside the studio and wait hours for him to finish doing his little rap song. And he finished it. And I was so excited because, I mean, he hadn't even left the studio when people were messaging me saying Rockstar's recording the diss track. And I was like, well, I wish he did it in time for the last show, but whatever, we can cope. We can wait. art, greatness takes time. And week after week went by. We saw some threats from DAN against Meek N. I'm assuming the Rockstar and Dan didn't show up to your gig at the Greta thing. I'm assuming he didn't. Oh, because you're here, you're still alive. He didn't deal his baseball bat blow like he does to the apps. No massacre. He didn't even show up to my event. Thank you so much for pinning that comment. That was a comment from Mika in there. So we recorded the diss track. And it wasn't leaked to me immediately, I have to say. Just that shitty little piece of gossip. Probably not even true. And over the weekend there, last week or something, the track gets leaked into my DMs, and I didn't tell anyone. I just kept it for the show. And then more people started sending it to me, and I was like, all right, it's not an exclusive then. Everybody has to, everybody's heard this. So hands up in the chat. Have you all heard this? Because I haven't heard it. I saved it specifically for the show to be fair and impartial. Meek M was offering me money to put a clown emoji over Rockstar's face in my thumbnail about the Craigavon massacre. I refused. I'm a fair and impartial judge. Okay? Let's see what the chat are saying before we get stuck into this diabolical diss track that is sure to end Meek N's career. Bum, bum. Right. Let's see what the chat are saying here. Can't wait to hear this P1 flow, says Disgrace. He couldn't deliver. I haven't heard it. Good work keeping it as a surprise, says Disgrace. Right, so it's the diss track we'd all be waiting for. So this has been leaked. He did not officially drop this, or has he officially dropped this? Let's go check his SoundCloud. Does anybody have his official SoundCloud handy? What's his SoundCloud? There's 2 million rock stars. Oh, here we go. We've got it. So, does anybody know what this song's called? Here's the song that Dan said Rockstar stole from him. I think it's this one, Armed and Dangerous. That's the one Dan said he stole off him, as far as I can remember. So, what is this? This one is just called Rockstar Meek N Diss. I think when it was sent to me, it was just a string of letters and numbers. Look at this here. We've got Rockstar featuring T-Mike, and the song is called The Streets. Oh, that's hilarious. T-Mike, one of the people who have demanded not to be covered in the show, and we have to give him his wish. That's always been the rule from day one. If you don't want to be in the show, you just have to ask. Okay, so, right. It's almost time to listen to the track. Does anybody know what the name of the track was? No joke answers. This is a serious political discussion. It's called Craigavon City, they're saying. That's good enough for me. Right, so we need a nice picture of Rockstar, I think. Let's get my thumbnail, the Craigavon Massacre, if I have it. Let's get that up on the screen. How do you spell Craigavon? Should we listen to Meek N's one time before we get stuck into this main one? There's Yaz Flap. He says, you're already spoiling. I asked for no spoilers in this song. You're already spoiling it. Meek N and this guy Yaz Flap spoiling the lines from the song. Ruining the one thing that I've been waiting my entire rap commentator career for. The Meek N Rockstar rap beef. This is the only shit that matters when it comes to rap, by the way. These sorts of wee beefs. They're doing diss tracks against each other. That's all that matters. Well, that's not, it's not called Craigavon City. Don't know why he's so hell-bent on referring to Craigavon as a city. Well, Dan told me he's not even from Craigavon either. It's just roundabout, says Ducky Mia. Right, okay, where's, let's see if we have this Meek N one to play first. Meek N demo? Or Meek N Irish rap? Irish Rasta? No, Meek N demo one? That's not it. Let's see. Popstar. We were listening to it. Oh, I've got Popstar here. We were listening to it on SoundCloud, I think. All right. This is the Popstar one. This is the initial track that Meek N dropped. Shout out to Atomic Adam for the beat. You could be a pop star.
Acting like a pussy, all you cats, you all in clicks. Saying you in charge, you ain't ever pushed a brick. Acting you got guns, but you've never pistol whipped. You've never been in trouble, bro, you've never emptied clips.
And as I said previously, that's a good thing. All right, that's a little refresher. Remember that pop star? And you remember this brilliant little thumbnail? This is my favorite thumbnail ever. We got the guys there looking to amazingly cool. Both of them looking like such cool gangster rappers. And ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, Rockstar, this is Meek N. With a wee song called The Meek N Diss Track. One for fire, two for shite in the chat right now. Rickety, rickety Rockstar. The most entertaining rapper alive, Rockstar. High bit, low bit rate song. Hopefully that was just an effect.
Acting like a faggot, all you do is suck a dicks.
With the banned F word that is not allowed in polite society. I wonder what OJ's BBC would think of that word, Rockstar.
Acting like a faggot, all you do is suck a dicks. Thinking you're hard, all you fucking thick. Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're
yo,
living in
it.
A bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a faggot, all you do is sucking dicks. Thinking you're
hard,
or you're fucking thick. Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a faggot, all you do is sucking dicks.
A semi-mea culpa.
Thinking you're hard, all you fucking thick. Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a faggot, all you do is sucker.
Sir, you can't be saying that on the Conor G Show. And I do love that this is a direct diss track back to Meek N. He's addressing things that Meek N said. He's using the same lyrical rhyming scheme here. I'm loving this.
Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a faggot,
stop
bubble,
saying
you do your sucking dicks. Thinking you're hard, or you're fucking thick. Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you got popped and I'll dip. Son, you're fucking phony, run and hide under a brick. Now you know I'm coming, you better do the bean. Let's see who's talking, I know you know him, but I mean jump star, pop star, yeah they call me rock star. Rock star, rock star, yeah they call me rock star. Yeah, I'm from Chicago, and at least I got a car.
Rockstar's come back with a diss track! Rockstar's come back with a wee diss track! Let's see what the chatter said about this. I don't see any of yous doing diss tracks. Meek N and Rockstar are doing diss tracks. Why aren't yous doing diss tracks?
From Kagaban and at least I got a car. Driving in star, you didn't call me Rockstar.
Yes! Yes, that's 100% fire they're saying in the chat. Can't spell Craigavon Massacre without ass, says Rare Witch. Popcorn emoji, says Atomic Adam. He was effing raging opening up like that. He's slurring like F those first few bars. He should have said acting like a bum talking poo. Yes, the most famous rock star lyric there. The deflection, says Ducky Mia. He needs to purchase his beats first before he starts to write them. He's just saying the same thing over and over, says Ducky Mia. As a one from Atomic Adam, one from Meek N, one from Yaz Flap, two from Ducky Mia. Where did he record that, says Atomic Adam? The studio formerly known as Hotbox Studio. You think OJ would have let this come out of his studio?
Rockstar, yeah, they call me Rockstar. Yeah, I'm from Craigavon and at least I got a car. Driving in a room, playing games. You don't shoot up what you say. Your cock's hard.
Ooh, so there's been three F banned F words, multiple wiener references. Let's hear the rest of it, says Rob.
What I mean, jump star, pop star, yeah, they call me rock star, rock star, rock star, yeah, they call me rock star, yeah, I'm from Kagawa.
Most people call him just by his real name, like as if using his real name would be an insult or something.
And at least I got a car, driving in a race, playing games.
Mumble rapper, they're saying.
Don't shoot up what you say, your cock's hard. Fucking mumble rapper, faggot.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Get balls.
This is like, I can't even play pretend to defend this, you know what I mean? Is that it, Syndrome? No, there's more. We are savoring this. This may never happen again in this Northern Irish rap scene. Something as funny and as fun as this.
On your fucking phony, run and hide under a brick. Now you know I'm coming, you better do the bean. Let's see who's talking, I know you know him, but I mean. Jump star, pop star, yeah, they call me rock star. Rock star, rock star, yeah, they call me rock star. Yeah, I'm from Craigavon and at least I got a car. Driving in a race, playing games. You don't shoot up what you say, your cock's hard.
Oh yeah.
Jesus Christ. He must have been proper raging recording this. It's 80% fire, 2% shite.
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys be at your front. Say sorry to my docs, you're about to feel a brunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. You're smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Looks like I'm staying home, the boys.
This is the line that everyone's been raving about. So, I have a question. Meek N, this isn't meant to be disrespectful here. I just don't know you. Are you gay? I don't know. I'm not being like, are you gay? Are you? I only buck broads, he says. So you're straight, okay? Okay. It's all right then. We don't want to further any hate speech here.
He said,
Yeah, I am actually gay. All right, well, that's a hate crime then. Get him locked up.
You need God. You're just a better cunt. You're smoking too much cocky.
I'm sorry to rewind such vulgarity here, but this has never been seen on the internet before. Where does the gay thing come from? Like, that's all that he has, just calling you gay. I mean, all you had was calling him ugly, pretty much, but...
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys...
That's what the beauty of a rap beef is.
Get your front, sister.
The stupidest nothing insults. I'm loving this rock star. I want to say, first of all, I'll be the first person to say thank you for doing a diss track back. That is the best case scenario for a rap beef. I love that he has taken the time to reply and reuse your lyrics against you. I love this. Replay pop star after this is Meek N. It'll pale in comparison.
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys be at your front. Say sorry to my docs, you're about to feel a brunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a bit of cunt. You're smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Looks. You're smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Looks at you. Looks at you. Smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Stick a grinder up your bum. Stick a grinder. Stick a grinder up your bum. Looks like. Just a better cunt. You're smoking too much cocky. Stick a grinder up your bum. Looks like.
See, I love DJing so much. I wish I started it when I was 10.
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys be at your front. Say sorry to my dad, cause you're about to feel a brunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. You're just a better cunt.
Oh my God, he is angry, he is angry. Everyone's saying how funny it is because he is actually angry. And that was it. And that was it, ladies and gentlemen. That was Rockstar's response diss track to Meek N. He killed it.
Bam, bam.
He killed it. I mean, apart from all the... apart from the only thing he had against Meek N was calling him an F word. OJ must be so ashamed. And he's one of OJ's circle of geniuses, his inner circle of geniuses. Oh man, you can't go mainstream doing stuff like that. I thought your whole thing was to go mainstream. It's like you can never go mainstream now. Oh, you shot yourself in the foot there a little bit, but aside from that, very funny. All right, there for Team Day, full rewind on that bad take. It's Rockstar's homophobic death threat to Meek N. Lock him up. One for fire, two for shit in the chat right now. I'm so sorry about this, Jakku. You put the G in LGBTQ. I mean, he should have been saying stuff like that.
Acting like a faggot, all you do is suck a dick's finger.
Oh, you're opening line. 2024. Acting like a... I can't even sing along to this, Rockstar. How am I supposed to sing along to this? I can't play this in the car. You crazy?
Hard.
This is like, I can't sing along with Emiliani's songs because he says the N-word every other word. I can't say this because you say the F word every other word.
Oh, you fucking third.
I want to put a grinder up your bum. Yeah, they're going to be putting that on t-shirts.
Acting like a bum. You're talking shit. You're living in a bubble. You get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a faggot. All you do, you're sucking dicks.
Sorry.
Thinking you're hard. Are you fucking thick? Acting like a bum. You're talking shit. You're living in a bubble. You got popped and I'll dip. Son, you're fucking phony. Run and hide under a brick. Now you know I'm coming. You better do the bean. Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean. Jumpstar pops. The bean. Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean.
Let's who's talking. You know what? Know him, what I mean. No, I don't know what you mean. In fact, we're going to isolate that line to make sure we didn't miss anything. Let's slow that down. Let's isolate.
Better do the bean. Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean. Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean.
Could someone type that out in the chat? What do they think this is? I'm not, my brain isn't catching it.
Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean.
Let's see who's talking or tucking. You know what I mean.
Jump star, pop star, yeah they call me rock star, rock star, rock star, yeah they call me rock star. Yeah, I'm from Cagavan and at least I got a car. Driving in a Riesling.
He's got you there. He's got you there.
If you don't shoot,
Louis Gracie on this one says Meek N.
What you say? Your cock's home.
Imagine not being able to record this cleanly and throwing that girl out. Ha ha ha! Says Disgrace. Immaculate vibes. Well, I think it's safe to say he actually wrote this one himself, at least. I don't know, some of those bum puns Collie B might have written for him.
Fucking mumble rapper faggot.
Mumble rapper F. I'm so sorry that that F word keeps slipping out. That's against my wishes. He probably thought if I say the F word enough, Connor won't play this on the show. We're making it out of the roundabout with this one, says Rich. Classic, scary, evil, beat type music production. Who's this producer tag here? Is it Yaz? Did you make that beat? Yaz is in the chat right now.
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys be at your front. Say sorry to my doctor about to feel a brunt.
Get to know me.
Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. You're smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like I'm staying home, the boys be at your front. Say sorry to my doctor about your...
No, says Yaz Flap in the chat. No what?
Feel a brunt, boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. You're just a better cunt.
DMX has entered the booth. You got a wee giggle at the end there to lighten the mood there. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Rockstar's diss track back. At Meek N. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for beholding the Conor G Show tonight. Ooh. Who had the better diss track? Who had the better diss track? Let's do a final poll here this evening. final vote here tonight. That's the best we can do. Okay, here's Pop Star by Meek N dissing Rockstar. Starting the feud.
Acting like a pussy, all you cats, you all in clicks. Saying you in charge, you ain't ever pushed a brick. Acting you got guns, but you've never pistol whipped. You've never been in trouble, bro, you've never empty clips. Acting like a pussy, all you cats, you all in clicks. Saying you in charge, you ain't ever pushed a brick. Acting you got guns, but you've never pistol whipped. Never been in trouble, bro, you've never empty clips.
Right, so while we say, what's the question that I want to ask here? Who's this got the other guy better?
Feeling like
yeah, this is Meek N.
Busting tricks. You've never seen this coming. You a vulture in the scene. And everyone be talking and they know what I mean.
I think I need to make this question a bit clear. Who won this round? Question mark. Meek N and Rockstar. There we go.
Tram star, pop star, wanna be a rock star. Tram star, pop star,
all right.
Wanna be a rock star. Say you from Cregavi, but you say you got a NASCAR. Driving in a box car, point the aim and shoot it, so you know it, that my shot's hard.
So final vote, ladies and gentlemen, who won? It was a Rockstar, Meek N. Now, I can tell you this right now, Rockstar got more ones than Meek N got, as far as I can tell. From my memory, if memory serves correctly, you can go check that out on youtube.com/ConorGillespie. You want to see what the original was.
Looking like a garden, you always out the front. Say sorry to your mom because she raised an ugly cult.
So that's one for Rockstar, two for Meek N. Okay, that one was Meek N that you just heard there. Here's Rockstar's hilarious diss track.
Acting like a faggot, all you do is sucking dicks. Thinking you're hard, all you fucking
Mayhem
thick.
Kobe, yeah.
Acting like a bum, you're talking shit. You're living in a bubble, you get popped and I'll dip. Acting like a f- all you do is sucking dicks. Thinking you're hard,
Nice sensor there by me.
Acting like a bum. You're talking shit.
Shit.
You're living in a bubble. You got popped and I'll dip.
One for Rockstar, two for Meek N.
Hide under a brick. Now you know I'm coming. You better do the bean. Let's see who's talking. I know you know him, but I mean. Jump star, pop star. Yeah, they call me Rockstar. Rockstar, Rockstar. Yeah, they call me Rockstar. Yeah, I'm from Cagavan and at least I got a car. Driving in a rain, playing games. You don't shoot at what you say. Your cock's hard.
Another perfect edit by me. The entertainment value of Rockstars is off the chat. That's two from Dokamiya, two from Jatsu. That's a two from Jakku, two from Dokamiya, two from Disgrace, two from Atomic Adam, two from Urwich. What does the garden gnome bar mean?
Sorry to my docs, you're about to feel a brunt. Boy, you need God, you're just a better cunt. You're smoking too much cocky, stick a grinder up your bum. Looks.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was your rap beef starring Rockstar and Meek N. What a glorious occasion this has been for the Conor G Show. Keep them beefs coming. That was the Conor G Show. Next week, Emcee, Paul Morrissey, and much, much more here live on the Conor G Show. If you want to support the Conor G Show, head over to conorg.show. Chip in and you'll be rewarded with the entire back catalogue of the Conor G Show, plus every other episode, which is behind the paywall. Thank you and good night. This one is Oisin Lid with Black Woman Cry. Who are we gonna raid into? Alright, let's raid the jungle bunker. Thanks, Tuggaslop. Thanks, Rob. Thanks, Rare Witch. Thanks, Disgrace. Thanks, Jakku. Thanks, Meek N. Thanks, Yaz, Adam. Everyone else who's dropped in, thanks for taking part in the Conor G Show. You rock! Looks like everybody's finished for the night. Going to raid into Grow TV. thank you, and good night. If I said anything to hurt or offend anyone, deeply take it back. It's not that serious. Just a stupid show, all right? Cheers, everybody, and see ya.